stage. We hear the ding of an elevator as it comes to a stop. An elevator voice says, "Bottom floor, the Department of Mysteries."
Lumos!
Luna, wait for me!
Come on, Neville!
Sorry, it's a nervous tic. I slow down whenever I have to hurry up.
Wow, we're here! The Department of Mysteries. Isn't it wonderful? All the world's most mysterious and magical anomalies in one booby-trap labyrinth. I want to see the Room of Death!
Can we just find
Smile,
the rest...
Smile, Neville!
Can we just find the rest of the DA before the Death Eaters gulp? Find us?
Oh, yeah, we're on a mission. The very last of the Death Eaters broke in, and we gotta catch him. Maybe I should turn my flash on. Oops, that was a good one. Neville, don't be such a guppy. What's the worst that could happen?
We could get caught by the Death Eaters.
I think you mean killed. We could get killed by the Death Eaters. Oh. That'd be a lot worse.
Oh, dear. Oh no, Death Eaters!
No. Oh, be merciful and kill us quickly!
Well, well, well. If it isn't Luna Lovegood, then Neville Schlongbottom.
Gasp! Fenrir Greyback!
Good, we kill them now.
Oh, these two little piggies are going to make a yummy snack. But not yet. For now, they'll serve as hostages. The rest of Dumbledore's army must be here. Somewhere.
You won't get away with this, you villains!
Oh, really? You DA brats have been a thorn in our side for your 6 years at Hogwarts. But tonight, we reclaim the ultimate weapon, and the Death Eaters shall rise again!
Your time is running out. Where is your hero now? You can look everywhere, but he's nowhere to be found. You look to your right. You're not gonna find him. You look to your left, he's not even there. Don't even try, he doesn't care about you. He's moved on. He's gone, he's gone, he's gone. This is the end.
Here it is. At last, finally, the ultimate artifact of evil is within my grasp. Now all of wisdom shall fall to the dark mark. You two, however, you won't be around to see the show. Oh, I've been working on this evil plan for so long. It's gotten scared to healthy appetites. Ah, and you two are gonna make a nice little weirdo sandwich with an extra side of moron.
Did somebody say Ron?
No.
I said no!
Stupefy! Oh, yes! Come on, guys! Let's get out of here!
This is the end of all the fighting. This is the end of people dying. This is the end. They're still trying to deny it's gonna be a sword them. This is the end.
Okay. We're supposed to meet Hermione in here.
Ron, there you are. Wait a second. Where are your guys' Death Eater disguises?
Neville, a Death Eater, protect me.
Take this, you Death Eater.
No! Oh!
This is for my family.
Oh!
No!
Oh!
No!
Oh!
No!
Oh!
No!
Oh! Oh!
Stop it, that's Hermione. That's my girlfriend. Oh, dear.
Oh, God damn it, Ron. I think my nose got broken. What's the damage?
Whoa. Hermione, I don't want to scare you or anything, but you look hot.
Well, I may look different, but you all should just treat me like the same old Hermione you know and love. And that goes for all of you, too. Ron, is that a book? I've never seen you carrying one of those before.
No, it's a diary. We're trying to keep it away from the Death Eaters.
And it's really fun.
My friends, let's finish this.
As you wish. Avada
Kedavra! Daylight Sphinx!
Oh. Oh no! My leg! My wrist, motherfucker! Where's the wizard cat? I'm the wizard cat!
Hey, thanks, good buddy.
Harry!
Well, chocolate frogs. Harry Potter did it again, y'all.
Kingsley Shacklebolt, the Minister of Magic.
And Chief of the Wizard Cops.
Word.
Well, now that y'all saved the world and rounded up the last of these dark magic turkeys, I gotta ask you, why the hell can't y'all kids just let me do my job for once?
Oh no, Mr. Shacklebolt, you don't understand. We had to stop those Death Eaters. Harry was having these visions.
Yeah, I already heard the whole story from your Defense Against the Dark Arts teacher. He's the one that let us know to come down here tonight. Come on in, Alistair.
Hello, hello.
Mad-Eye Moody!
That's right. It's some fine work you done here, Porter. I taught you well.
Thanks, Professor.
And you defeated Fenrir Greyback, did you?
He sure did.
Nice. Very nice.
Looks like the Death Eaters were after this, but we managed to keep it away from them.
And it's a good thing you did, Miss Granger. If the Death Eaters were to get a hold of that, the entire world would be in jeopardy. Best hand that over to me now. I'll keep it nice and safe.
Oh, I'm sure you would, Professor Moody. Or should I say, Barty Crouch?
Blimey. All right. Nobody move. Walls on the ground. Walls on the ground right now. Put him in a pile. I'm not f***ing around this time. Come on. All right. So, Porter, how'd you know it was me?
I had my suspicions for a while. It was briefly mentioned Mad-Eye Moody had died during my second year, but I wasn't sure if it was you until tonight. Now you're gonna answer for your crimes, Barty Crouch.
Oh, yeah? I've got a better idea. Just let him move a goddamn muscle. Me and Mr. Shacklebolt over here gone for a little trip on the flu network. And none of you jive-ass bobbies are gonna follow, you dig?
We dig, Moody. We dig.
Well, Barty, if you're gonna go on a vacation, I know a first-rate hotel that offers free bodyguard service and meals. It has every amenity in the world. One could live there.
Oh, really? Sounds like they require some reservations.
Nope, you don't need one. For Hotel Azkaban.
Yeah.
Porter, always a joker. You self-righteous son of a bitch. Oh, what's the matter, Porter? Afraid of a little muggle toy? Well, let's even the stakes then. It's just you and me now. Let's settle it the old-fashioned way. Mono a mono. Man to man. Fist to face. Come here, you little bastard.
Stupefy!
No! That was some quick thinking. It just saved my life. But that still doesn't excuse what you kids did here tonight. Breaking into the Department of Mysteries, flying thresholds right through the Queen's Day Parade. You kittens may think Dumbledore's army can take on the world, but y'all should have let me know the minute you heard some funky shit was going down here tonight.
Sorry, Kingsley, we just didn't have the time.
You know what, Potter boy, bitch boy, Potter? You're a hot shot loose cannon. It's that kind of maverick attitude that makes you perfect for the Wizard Cops.
Wow!
So what do you say, HP? You ready to join the force and take a bite out of crime?
I'd love to, but I can't.
And why the hell not?
Because I'm going back to Hogwarts. Senior year starts September 1st.
All right, well, you're right, Potter. It's a shame, though. You would have made one good goddamn wizard hell of a wizard cop. All right, boys, let's get out of here.
Beaten again, huh? You Death Eaters never learn. Your Dark Lord's been dead for 5 years. Why do you guys keep hanging on to something that's over?
If it's over for me, then it's over for you, too. You see, all you are is someone who fights us. Once we're all gone, the world won't need a hero anymore. If the Dark Lord can't live forever, then neither can you.
Take him away.
Scene 2. Lights up on the Burrow.
Rise and shine, Weasleys! It's September 1st, and you know what that means. You little knuckleheads better be dressed and packed and ready to leave for school after breakfast.
Mom, have you seen my boyfriend, Harry Potter?
No, I haven't, dear. I've got all these extra kids in the house. Bill's wife, Ron's girlfriend, Harry's girlfriend. I'm swamped. Would you go and wake everybody up for me?
Okay.
Ginny walks up a crooked staircase to the bedroom, where she finds Ron sitting on the edge of the bed, lightly strumming a guitar and singing with his meager voice.
Hey!
Sorry, Ron.
Hey, Harry Potter, it's time for breakfast!
Ah! Who ever heard of knocking? Get out of my room!
Ooh, it's my room too, Ronald. What are you doing in here anyway?
None of your beeswax, thunder butt.
He's writing a love song for his girlfriend.
Charlie, get out of here!
I think it's romantic.
Floor?
I think you're romantic.
just get a room, you two.
This is our room.
Will you guys shut your fat faces? It's the Ashback of Dawn!
Percy, you're just jealous of Ronnie's girlfriend? And my beautiful wife.
As if. Ah! You're gonna go sleep in the garden. At least the gnomes are quiet.
No, Percy, don't go out there. Hermione's reading in the garden.
So? Why isn't she in here with you, Mr. Perfect?
Yeah, what's up, Ron? Why didn't Hermione crawl into bed with us last night?
Yeah. Well, she was up late reading. We haven't been spending too much time together because she's really into these young adult novels lately. I thought I could sweep Hermione off her feet if I wrote her a song. I'm just trying to get her to kiss me again.
Well, when was the last time she kissed you, buddy?
Let me think. Yeah, it was that first time.
Ron, as someone who is so very happy in love, I have advice for you. Just how you say, be yourself.
Yeah, Ron. Girls don't want cheesy compliments or songs or surprise presents.
Just then, Harry literally surfs into the room on a heart-shaped guitar, being held up by enchanted rose petals. Harry then surfs onto the bed and flips the guitar into the air. He sings.
Ginny, 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 you're cool. You're my girlfriend. I love you so much. You're hotter than all the other girlfriends that ever were in the world.
Oh, I love you, Ginny Weasley. You're the most magical creature I've ever seen in my whole life. Surprise! A present from your boyfriend.
Oh, what is it? What is it? What is it?
Oh, a diary.
Harry Potter, you are the best boyfriend ever. No, I'm gonna go write in it right now.
Hey, Ron. Hey, Weasleys.
Hey, good buddy.
Guys, thanks for letting me stay at the Burrow all summer.
Hey, no problem.
problem, pal. I'm just sorry you had to share a bed with Ginny. It must be weird sleeping with your girlfriend.
No, it was weird that your mom was there, too. And you, and your whole family, like, all in one bed. You guys are so poor.
Well, are y'all packed for Hogwarts?
Yep, I got my invisibility cloak, the piece of the mirror Sirius gave me, and my talk boy. But what I can't find is my lucky snitch.
Do you mean the one Dumbledore left you when he died?
Yeah, have you guys seen it? It has an inscription on the side that says, I opened the clothes, whatever the f*** happened.
Man, I am literally surrounded by people kissing. Bill and Flora, you and Ginny, I want to do that.
Dude, she's your sister, just ask her.
Oh, wow. Our young depressed heroine reluctantly settles for the doughy boy next door. Another perfect ending to another perfect young adult novel series. The Hunger Games by Gilderoy Lockhart.
I'm sorry. Who's Gilderoy Lockhart?
Who's Gilderoy Lockhart? He's only my favorite author and idol. He's given the world so many amazing novel series, like the Twilight series, The Hunger Games, Percy Jackson, and whatever he did.
Twilight? Oh, yeah, I've heard of that. I don't like how those books objectify men.
Oh, yeah? Have you ever read them? Have you ever even read a book?
Have you ever not read a book?
No. God, I can't stand people who don't read. Ron, did you finish The Hunger Games? I gave you the first book weeks ago.
Yes. Yes, it was good. It was a good game.
Oh yeah. What was it about?
It was about hungry, withholding girl who won't kiss her boyfriend!
You did read it! Hey, you guys! I already pulled my diary, so now I'm gonna tell you. It's time for breakfast.
They walk downstairs to the dining room. The table is set. Bill, Fleur, and the other Weasleys enter.
Bonjour, Weasleys!
Sorry my girlfriend couldn't be here, everyone, but the Wi-Fi, I just can't get it to work.
I am just so sad. This is the last meal we have with these boys before they leave me for a whole year. I can't wait until you're all done with Hogwarts, and then you can just move back in here with me, like all my other children. Even Fred came back from the dead as a ghost to stay at home.
Oh, the light! I see the light! Oh, guess it's time to go now. Guess I won't be able to do the dishes. Looks like Percy will have to cover for me.
Oh, Fred, knock it off.
What, I'm Fred?
That goes for you too, Harry. The second you're done at Hogwarts, you are more than welcome to move right in here.
Oh, golly, that's really nice of you, Mrs. Weasley.
So, are you moving in or not?
I don't know. I guess I never thought about life after Hogwarts. It's the only home I've ever really known. I can't even begin to imagine what it's like to leave behind.
Well, you don't have to worry about that, Harry. You still got your whole senior year ahead.
Speaking of senior year, Ronnie, my boy, I've got a present for you. It's a Weasley family tradition. It's the keys to the flying car!
Yay!
Here you go, son! And you can have it all year!
This is gonna be the best year ever!
Yep, it sure is!
Oh, wow.
Cheers, everybody! To senior year!
To senior year!
Going back to Hogwarts for the very last time.
Our final year, at last it's here, gonna start our lives.
Everyone's excited about what the future holds for you. what the world's most famous wizard is gonna get into.
Well, we're going back today in the very same old way. Tell me, Harry, can't you hear? It's gonna be your year. It's a very Potter.
I never thought that we would get this far, but we made it, we're on top of the world.
We're on top of the world.
I feel unstoppable, I'm supercharged.
It's contagious, that's for sure. We're on top of the world.
We'll have some cool new spells to learn, and we're gonna earn good grades.
You're gonna spend lots of time with me, and this is gonna be the very best year.
It's a very Potter.
Windshield to see Hogwarts off in the distance.
There it is, Harry. Hogwarts.
God, she's beautiful.
As they descend, the ride becomes very turbulent.
Whoa, whoa, Ron, Ron, keep it steady, man. Don't hit the wall. Go over it, Amy. Go.
Okay, dude, I'm trying. Oh, oh, we're going down. Hold on.
To what?
Scene 3. Lights up on the smoking wreckage of the flying car, which has crashed into the herbology room of Hogwarts, completely destroying it.
Oh, whoa. Wipeout.
Ron, look what you did.
Hey, at least we crashed into the herbology room. Always saved that class. Let's get out of here before we get in any trouble.
Oh, in the name of stuffy old ninnies everywhere, what is going... Potter!
Professor McGonagall!
Look what you've done to the greenhouse! An entire crop of mandrakes destroyed! It'll take all year to grow another! Oh, and look, you killed Professor Sprout!
Oh,
You'd better have a jolly good explanation for all of this, Potter, or I'll expel you so fast your head will spin faster than a fizzing fancy.
Guys, let me take care of this.
Professor, this isn't what it looks like. You see, we couldn't have destroyed the biology room because, it was like this when we got here.
Yeah.
Potter, I know I may not be as hip as Dumbledore was, but I am headmaster of this school now. I consider myself to be a very reasonable, uptight bitch. But if you haven't got a witness to back up your story, it's out of my hands, Potter.
Well, well, well. What a fine opportunity that has fallen straight from the sky right into my diapered lap.
Malfoy.
How fortuitous that I happen to be exploring the next room with my bilingual friend Dora when I witnessed the entire happenings of what happened here tonight.
Oh, thank goodness, Draco. Can you please clear up this whole mess?
Indeed I can. But first I'd like to point out to Mr. Potter that I now hold his fate in the palm of my tiny hand.
Malfoy, you little shit.
And I can assure you, Headmaster, that these fellows are entirely innocent.
What? Well, then who is responsible for this severe property damage?
Isn't it obvious? Sorry, old friend. It was Dora.
Miss Explorer! I am shocked. You're coming with me immediately.
It looks like this is the end of our adventure, Dora. I really did love you.
Te amo también. Lo siento.
You kids had better hurry off to the great hall for the welcoming feast. Spitzbot, off you go.
Shwoo! That was close.
All right, Malfoy. What's the deal?
What? Surprised that I could pin your crime on that saucy tart? I'm not denying it, I did sleep with her. But she's been seeing my Paddington Bear behind my back for weeks now. As you can see, Potter, it's very dangerous to be one of my enemies. Which is why it's such a good thing that we're friends.
Yeah, right, Malfoy. I'll never be your friend. Come on, guys.
No! Right now, surely you chaps remember all the good times we had at school together. Like when we battled Professor Quirrell and I destroyed that last Horcrux. Or when I traveled back in time and saved you from my evil father.
No, I don't really remember that. I was 11.
Well then, surely you chaps remember our third year. The most memorable and important one. When we all went to pig farts. I did many important things that year, and we had so many clean jokes and good songs, and nobody swore.
Oh, yeah, no, I remember that year. F*** that year.
Well, we've only got 1 year left, chaps. What do you say we bury the hatchet and enjoy it? Like good friends should, huh?
Whatever, Malfoy, just butt out, scram, would you?
As in, get your poopy butt out of here.
All right, dudes. Until next time, you hang loose.
Bloody nuts! It's Harry Potter!
Hey,
what's good? What's good?
My brother.
Sousers, bouncers, Harry Potter! Oh, mind a few picks for the school paper?
Oh, who's this?
Oh, it's Colin Creevy, sir. First year. I just got sorted into Gryffindor, and I'm a big fan.
Oh, is that so? That's what I like to hear. Hey, be sure to get on my good side, huh?
All right, Jillikers.
I can tell that kid has a long and illustrious career ahead of him.
All right, children, silence. Welcome one and all to another magical year at Hogwarts. Now, before I introduce this year's Defense Against the Dark Arts teacher, I would like to present this year's newly chosen head girl, Miss Cho Chang.
Caviar.
Now, I would have presented this year's head boy, but sadly the young man who was chosen was murdered at the end of last term by Fenrir Greyback. So, we cannot leave the school head boyless. So, for the first time, we will present the first ever Hogwarts head boy election. We have chosen two male candidates who will campaign throughout the first term, at the end of which there will be a school-wide vote to determine this year's head boy. So, the first candidate is none other than Harry Potter! And Draco Malfoy!
Yes. Draco?
It is with a heavy heart that I accept this civic duty. Of course, my vote will be going to Harry Potter, whom I believe to be the best man for the job.
Thank you, Malfoy. I'll be voting for myself as well.
You will each be given a campaign budget of $50.
Ooh!
Once you have settled upon a campaign manager.
And for my campaign manager, I pick my most trusted underling, Crabbe and Goyle. Goyle? What the devil is Crabbe?
Me and Crabbe were in the room of requirements. We started a fire and Crabbe's dead.
Oh. Oh no. I was counting on his vote.
Cheer up, old friend. Take heart. I met this new guy on the train, and he seems pretty cool.
Candy from the trolley, dear?
Oh, brimstone and broil. She'll have to do.
This is great. For a while I was worried, but without Crabbe, Malfoy doesn't stand a chance, ma'am.
Yeah, Harry, you got this election in the bag.
Oh, I wouldn't be so sure of that. Bloody piss! It's
the Roy Lockhart!
Whoa! Yes, yes. Hello, ladies and ladies.
Oh. Children. I would like to present this year's Defense Against the Dark Arts teacher, New York Times bestseller, and all-around heartthrob, Mr. Gilderoy Lockhart!
Why, thank you, Headmaster. You're too kind for your own good, and a little too foxy for mine.
That's the most famous wizard in the world, that is!
Whoa, 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 guys. Guys, I think you mean the second.
Well, Harry Potter, we meet at last. Yes, I've heard all about your heroic deeds in the past. Oh, didn't you kids hear? Harry Potter used to be cool.
Used to be cool?
What you talking about?
I guess you've all been locked up in this horrible school for so long that you've lost touch with the real wizarding world.
Yeah, but Harry just saved the real wizarding world from real Death Eaters. So.
Boring! I mean, how sick are we of seeing Harry Potter beat Death Eater after Death Eater after Death Eater in these long, drawn-out episodes? I mean, how many years ago did the Dark Lord die? 5? And here's Harry Potter still dating the same butter-faced girl since he was 12. I mean, when will it end so we can all move on with our lives?
Yeah!
No, no, no! You're wrong, Gilderoy. People love me. My adventures aren't repetitive. They're familiar, and they're comforting. Besides, if the whole wizarding world isn't obsessed with Harry Potter, then what are they obsessed with?
Why, that would be me. I'm telling you, children, take one step off the grounds of Hogwarts, and you know what they'll be talking about. A forbidden love between a young girl and a Dracula monster. Twilight, now a major motion picture.
Ooh.
Yes, the world has grown weary of Harry Potter. He's nothing more than a passing fad, entirely old hat.
Old hat? Old hat? I'm not an old hat. You're an old hat. How's this for an old hat, huh? You know? Hermione can't draw. Hermione can't draw. Hermione cannot draw. She can't draw.
That's not even funny anymore. That is rude and insensitive.
Wait, but guys, come on. Come on. Come on! Nobody delivers classical musical hijinks like your old pal HP, right?
Oh, why anyone could strum that silly old lyre. It takes a real man to tickle the ivories. Who's wiser than a warlock, and tougher than a troll, and charming as a candy cane? cools faster than a phoenix and sly as a sphinx and always set to entertain. Here to give this sagging tale a hero to employ. Look up to the skies, now look in my eyes. It's Gilderoy, who's handsome as a hobbit and manly as a mare, and always gives the girls a wink. Who's funny as a ferret and quick as a quill, and always sings without a lip sync. Here to rid your nostrils of that dreadful Potter boy, 'cause that smell in the air is the marvelous flare of, excuse me, Gilderoy. Long ago lived a fellow who caught your eye, hair that curled in a beautiful fro. Now it's gone and replaced with a suit and tie, dancing in a variety show. Oh, where did he go? Does he even care at all? Recently, he's been acting very queer. Every day, his story grows more and more. Now, and Voldemort isn't coming this year. Gilderoy is here to fill your short attention spans. Why look at that wonder boy when you could be looking at a wonder man?
You could be looking at a wonder man.
Who was with another year? 7 times in 7 years. Who was it?
Gilderoy.
Who conquered all his fears and made a Bogart disappear? Go on, say it.
Gilderoy.
Who taught a Yeti how to sing?
Gilderoy.
Walked into Mordor and destroyed the ring.
Gilderoy.
That old banshee came out a champ.
Gilderoy.
Far inside of a lamp.
Gilderoy.
Stories of wonder for each girl and boy. Paperback, a hardback for you to enjoy. Form an orderly line.
It's Gilderoy.
Ladies, one at a time.
It's Gilderoy.
Give me something to sign.
It's Gilderoy.
All sales are final. Soon the school will be mine.
It's Gilderoy.
That song was okay, but check this out. I'm Harry freaking Potter.
Hi.
I would witch in all your
gadgets.
I'm, you know, Come on, ow. Oh man, what is this? Ow, oh God, I feel something. It's not like a bummer. It's not even like it's like a drag, but worse. How am I feeling?
Harry. Don't listen to what Gilderoy says. Everybody likes you, even if nobody likes you anymore.
That's what it is. No, he's right. He's right, Jenny. I'm boring. I'm predictable. I keep doing the same stuff every year. I keep fighting the same dudes, date the same girl. I'm an old hat.
Well, you know what they say about an old hat. It fits like a glove.
No, I gotta shake things up. I gotta change everything. I gotta stay fresh. Have a forbidden love of my own. Then people won't forget about me, ever.
Yeah.
Ginny, I'm sorry. We gotta break up.
What? But we love each other. Don't we?
Ginny, it's not that I don't like you. It's that other people don't like me. It's nothing personal.
But I need you. My body needs you. I gave you 5 years of my life.
Yeah, and they were some bodacious years. We had some great times. I will never throw out all the shit you bought. But I'm sure you will never forget how hard I rocked your world.
This is it. Just like this. Just goodbye.
This isn't like goodbye. It's just, you know, you're cramping my style.
Well, you know what?
Ginny, that's not fair. You know I'm so conscious about that.
What's up her butt?
Sorry, man, but I broke up with your sister.
Oh my God, I gotta tell you, I hated pretending to be nice to your girlfriend because I couldn't stand my stupid little sister. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah, it feels so good.
I just hope she's okay.
Who cares? You're a free man. You can do anything you want. You can finally go on that date with Cho Chang, y'all.
Maybe, I don't know. But let's first concentrate on making sure that I'm still the most popular kid in school. Let's win that head boy election, huh?
Scene 4. Lights up on the girls' bathroom.
No! Please! Please don't let it be too real.
Hey! Shut up over there! People are trying to use this bathroom and they're not doing it!
I'm sorry, Moaning Myrtle. I'm just heartbroken.
Oh! Oh! Poor baby! Harry Potter's girlfriend's dead! Because she's still alive! Does baby want some wine with that cheese? F*** you!
Understands you, Ginny. Somebody who knows what it's like to be filled with hate.
Diary?
I'm a journal. Not a diary. Diaries are for girls. But yes, Ginny, I'm a magic diary. Shit, journal. I'm a magic journal. Enchanted with the spirit of its former owner.
Harry?
No.
But Harry gave it to me.
Read the name on the cover, stupid.
Oh. Okay. Tom.
Okay, just skip that name. It's a made-up name for this letter rearranging trick. You'll find it later. Just go to the next name.
Oh. Rydell.
Yeah. Tom Riddle. I'm a piece of his soul, separated from the whole and bound to this diary. Shit! Journal! Bound to this f***ing journal!
Oh, but what do you want, diary?
To help you, Ginny.
Oh.
That's what journals are for. See, I once was like you, alone, angry. The world had turned its back on me.
Well, what did you do, diary?
Let me show you in a magic flashback. It all started when I was a boy, an orphan boy.
Lights down on Ginny, lights up on the magic flashback. We find ourselves at Wool's Orphanage many years ago.
I think you'll find Wool's Orphanage is a first-rate
trade establishment. We have 7 different breeds of orphan, including street urchin, rosy-cheeked, delightfully small, and 1 little evil telekinetic antichrist. Now, what was it you were interested in today, Mr.?
Dumbledore! Elvish Dumbledore! But you can call me Dumby, or, Big D. You know, the D stands for, my doctorate. I'm a professor at a school for very magical children. Ah, shit. I mean, very regular children.
Oh. Well, you're in luck, Big D, because we have plenty of those in stock. Follow me.
Yeah, well, just listen, Dollface. I'm here to see one little cutie in particular. That, Tom Riddle. I think he might be just right for our school.
Tom Riddle? Suit yourself. But I warn you, this boy's a monster. Thomas, you have a visitor, Professor Dumbledore.
How do you do, Tom?
Professor, like a doctor. So they've come here to take a look at me, have they? Well, there's nothing wrong with me.
Just stop shouting, Mr. Man. He's from a school. He might just take you off my hands, you filthy little heathen.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Cole. I think I can take it from here. Now get the hell out of here, please.
Why don't you get out of here, too? You're not gonna want me. She's right, you know. I'm evil.
You are not evil, Tom.
Yes, I am. Mrs. Cole told me that my mommy died when I came out of her tummy. The first thing that I ever did was kill somebody.
Well, Tom, you know, sometimes you accidentally kill your family. There's nothing to beat yourself up about. Hey, listen. You know who accidentally killed his sister while he was in a fight with his boyfriend? This guy right here.
You've killed people too?
Oh yeah, tons of times. But it doesn't make me bad. And it doesn't make you bad. There are just some things you don't know about yourself yet. All you need is a big, strong hand to put you on the right path. Tell me, Tom, do you ever feel like you're a little bit different from the other little boys?
Uh-huh.
Sometimes you can make extra special things happen. Silly, silly fun things.
Well, sometimes when I'm really happy, I can shoot sparkles out of my fingers.
Cass! Do you know what that means, Tom? That means you're a magic boy.
What?
That means you're a magic boy. Those sparkles from your hands, that's magic. You're a wizard, Tom.
Oh, boy. I knew I was special.
And you are going to come with me, and I'm going to take you to a magical school for wizards with a silly name. You want to know the name?
Uh-huh.
It's Hogwarts.
That's funny.
And in Hogwarts, the professors are giant people and tiny people and werewolves and cats. And we play games. Oh, and there's no f***ing homework. All we learn how to do is sing and dance.
Yay! Yahoo! Sparkles!
Oh, Tom, look at that sparkly magic.
Yay!
You look as gay as the 4th of July.
Yay! I'm magic. I'm gay.
Me too! Tom, from this moment forward, you're turning over a new leaf. Now you are a boy, an orphan boy, and deep inside of you, a broken soul, a gaping hole, has left you feeling blue. But you're not like the other boys, you've got that magic flair, 'cause when you start to sway, you get carried away. And no one can compare. I've I've been watching you play. I've been listening to the things that you say. And I've come to tell you today, you're no ordinary blighter. You've got a broken heart. You keep reaching inside to tear it apart. But I'm here to give you a brand new start and to make your spirit brighter. When all the other boys start to laugh and jeer, I know a secret way you can make them disappear. You've got that talent, kid, so here is your chance. They might not understand, but just stick to the plan and show them all it's time to dance. Always dance, always dance. Though they'll try to stop you, always dance. Shut your mouth and stop your yapping. Take your foot and set it tapping. You were born a magic boy, so neat and twirl and prance. And Tommy always dance.
Are you ready to go to Hogwarts?
I've been waiting to go. For how long, I really don't know. But one look at you and I know that you would never fool me. I've been living a lie ever since I made my poor mommy die. I've been softly wondering why they all choose to ridicule me.
When all the other boys start to laugh and jeer, I know a secret way I can make them disappear. You've got that talent, kid.
This is my chance.
They might not understand, but just stick to the plan and show them all it's time to dance. Always dance, always dance. Though they'll try to stop you, always dance. Shut your mouth and stop your yapping. Take your foot and set it tapping.
I was born a magic boy. I leap and twirl and prance.
Though Tommy always dance.
Slytherin!
Wait, Tom. Your sorting is not done yet. The scarf of sexual preference.
Oh, interesting. I could see you going a number of ways.
Hello there.
Hi.
My name is Lucius, but you can call me Louie. When I grow up, I want to be a rocket.
And I'm Trixie. I like Hogwarts because there's lots of nice friends to make and yummy food to eat.
Are you making fun of me?
No. You want to be friends? Gasp. What a man.
We'll see how much of a man you are. Care for a friendly dance-off?
Do I?
Take your foot and set it tapping. He was born a
Ginny.
When the world sucks, just dance. And the world always sucks, so always dance. Dance with me.
Oh boy, yeah.
You've got the talent, kid, so you're my nominee. They might not understand, but you will dance with me. Always dance, always dance, though they'll try to stop us, always dance. You were born for my control, so step into my trance.
Scene 5, lights up on Gilderoy Lockhart's autograph line. Several kids wait to meet Gilderoy, including Hermione, who stands at the end of the line. Gilderoy finishes signing a headshot for Luna.
There you are, Miss Lovegood. Thanks for stopping by. Okay, who's next? Oh, why, hello, Neville. It's nice to see a boy in my line for a change.
Oh, thank you, sir. Katniss Everdeen is my idol.
Here you are. Next.
Hello, Gilderoy Lockhart.
Hello there. It's $40 for a headshot and $30 for an autograph.
If you could just sign my copy of Breaking Dawn, that would be great.
No, I only sign the $40 headshots.
Oh, so really an autograph is just $70.
Well, aren't you clever? You must be Hermione Granger.
You know who I am?
Oh, yes. Professor Flitwick says you're an aspiring young writer. He says your translations of Beetle the Bard's boring stories had him on the edge of his seat. And that's saying something, because if that small man were to fall from a chair, he could die.
Oh. Well, I don't know how good my writing is. I mean, that Beetle the Bard translation was just something silly for fun. My true passion is fan fiction. Based on your work.
Oh, really?
Yes, and in fact, here's one fanfic I'm working on right now. In it, you're a capital person, and you are dating Effie Trinket, but then you fall in love with this sort of mousy, underspoken Avox. And then the Avox regains her ability to speak, and she has a beautiful voice, and she's kind of like the coolest girl in the whole wide world, so if you wanted to read it, you could, but if you don't want to, that's okay, too.
A mousy girl, eh? Well, let's have a look-see. Oh my God, Hermione, this is absolutely depraved. I love it.
Really?
Hell yes. This makes 50 Shades of Grey look like a fucking book for kids. With writing like this, you could be going places. In fact, I have been looking for someone to write my autobiography. I mean, my biography.
You mean me? You would want me to write your story?
Perhaps, but I'll need to see some more samples of your writing.
Oh, I can bring you some more of my fanfics. I have this one where I'm Kato and you're one of the wolf mutations and you graphically eat me. Among other things.
No, fanfiction won't do. I need to see how you craft real life into drama. What do you say you write me a few essays on someone you know? Someone at Hogwarts. So, I don't know, Harry Potter?
Harry? Well, Didn't you say yourself, sir, that Harry's life is repetitive and mundane?
Well, if you don't think you could do it, I suppose I'll have to find someone else. It sounds funny to say now. I thought you were special.
I am special.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. I'll do it. I'll write about Harry.
That a girl. Why don't you just write me an essay on each of Harry's years at Hogwarts?
All right. I'll do it, Gilderoy Lockhart. And I won't let you down. In fact, I'm going to go get started right now.
If I'm going to win this head boy election, I've got to have a strong campaign platform. Something like, end house elf slavery. Begin muggle and mudblood slavery. Something inspiring like that. Goyle, Candy Lady, how are those campaign posters coming? A candidate is only as good as his placards. Goyle?
I drew an old, majestic owl.
Yes, it's a fine rendering, but it has very little to do with me or the election. But perhaps maybe if you had a speech bubble coming out of the owl's mouth that said, vote for Malfoy, he's a hoot.
I don't think the owl would say that.
And sometimes I think maybe Hermione doesn't want to kiss me because, oh my God, do you think she likes someone else?
I don't know, maybe she likes Fluffy. They'd be a good couple because they're both dogs. Ho!
Ha ha.
Woof.
Ha ha. Well, you know, I'm just worried because she's not hanging out around us lately and she's so busy with those stupid books.
Well, she better remember to do my potions essay because it's due tomorrow. Hey, this looks like a good spot, huh? Right here. This looks like a really good spot. Got the campaign poster?
Right here.
Great. All right, so the rules of this election are that you can only run positive campaigns. That's why no one's going to be expecting this. Good work, Mr. Campaign Manager. Now let's see who votes for Malfoy. What are you laughing at?
This.
What? Wait, what? Hold on. What are you laughing at? Potter stinks. Wait a sec. Hey. It's not funny at all. Wait, Lavender, where'd you get that button?
So it was just passing them out to everyone in school.
Who? Tell me!
That was really mean, Harry. You stink, and not just because of your toots.
What? Who made that pin? Run! Do I smell like toots? Well, do I?
No.
Then why is everybody saying I stink? Who's responsible for this?
Malfoy is a snobbish, racist, elitist brat. Sums up my entire campaign perfectly. Who's responsible for this beautiful placard? Goyle, is that yours?
Malfoy, you must be behind all this Potter stinks crap.
Hey.
Get rid of the buttons, Malfoy, or I'll kick you off my street team. Then we'll see who checks your tumblers.
Harry Potter, I would never make up a rumor about you. I treasure our friendship. Don't you remember all those times at school
when Draco speaks, the lights dim and his voice fades away. In its place, Harry can hear an eerie, mysterious voice that echoes from somewhere in the distance.
Snake. I'm a snake. Oh, where'd my arms go? Just kidding, I'm a snake.
Did you guys hear that?
Hear what?
I'm gonna eat so many of you stupid humans that I'm free. Then you can even hear me. Ooh, there's one. Take this.
What the devil was that?
It came from down there. Come on.
Harry and Draco run off to investigate. Ron, Goyle, and the Candy Lady follow. The gang eventually run into Colin Creevy, who stands motionless in the center of the stage. Ginny stands there, her hands covered in blood. On the wall behind her is a message written in blood.
Ginny? Hey, Colin! Are you okay, little buddy?
Oh,
What is that?
The Chamber of Secrets has been opened. Enemy of the air, beware. Oh, that's quite good. Now, just add, your next Mudbloods vote for Malfoy.
What's going on in here?
Wait, listen, Professor, I'm not lying this time. This really was like this when I got here.
Oh boy, is Colin dead?
No, he's still alive, but he appears to be petrified.
What does that mean, Professor?
Just what the note says, Miss Chang. The Chamber of Secrets has been opened.
Professor, what's the Chamber of Secrets?
A hidden dungeon somewhere inside Hogwarts, built by Salazar Slytherin himself. The legend goes that one day, Slytherin's heir would use Parseltongue, snake language, to open the chamber and unleash a monster.
Ooh.
No, 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 not cool! Everyone back to your dormitories. I'm taking Mr. Creevy to the infirmary.
Oh, whoa, Harry. This can't be good. The Chamber of Secrets monster? What?
You're right, Ron. You're very right. This isn't good at all.
It's great! Huh?
Don't you get it, Ron? All I have to do is save the school again, and everyone's gonna forget about this Potter stinks crap, and I'll win the head boy election and prove that Harry Potter is still the number one wizard in the world.
Awesome! Where do you want to start?
Wait, what? Did you want me to help? Because I figured you would just get this one. Mr. Campaign Manager, you got it. Besides, I can't help right now. I got a date with Cho Chang.
La 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 la.
Scene 6. Lights up on the girls' bathroom. Ginny furiously tries to wash the blood from her hands in the sink.
How did this blood get all over my hands anyway?
Hey, Ginny.
Oh, are you washing blood off your hands too?
No.
Hey, did you hear that the Chamber of Secrets has been opened?
How exciting.
Well, see ya.
Chamber of Secrets opened. Hands covered in blood. Message written in blood. Wait a second. I must be having a... Nope. I lost it. Oh, Ginny, you think too much. Diary time. Yum. Okay. Dear Diary, I need some help. Something weird is happening. Do you know anything about the Chamber of Secrets?
Maybe.
Oh, can you tell me about it or show me in another magic flashback?
Another magical flashback begins. Lights go down on Ginny and come up on Dumbledore and Madame Pomfrey, who stand in a hallway looking down at a young girl's dead body.
I'm sorry, Headmaster. I've done everything I could. But I'm afraid she's dead.
Ah, damn.
Do you think it's true what the children are saying? That this is the work of the monster of the Chamber of Secrets?
Well, let's not jump to any conclusions, Madam Pom-Pom. We keep a lot of killer monsters in this school. This one might not have been from the Chamber of Secrets. At least I hope not.
Professor Dumbledore, wanted to see me?
Yes, Tom. Just one second, please.
All right, slaves. See you later at the club meeting.
Sure thing, Tom.
Malloy! How many times do I have to tell you to call me?
My Dark King. Right.
Thank you. That wasn't so hard, was it? I mean, I remember your name. Now, scram!
Well, Pom-Pom, I guess you could just take this poor girl down to the kitchen and feed her to the house elves. Actually, wait, just give me a second. I want to try this thing one more time. F***ing work. Oh, come on! Worst Deathly Hallow ever!
What is that?
Oh, it's just called the Resurrection Stone. Supposed to bring people back from the dead, but I can't really get it to work.
Stone? That brings people back from the dead? I want that.
Hey, hands off, you little scamp. This is going back to my office where it belongs. And speaking of little Miss Deadpants, you wouldn't happen to have anything to do with a death, Tom, would you?
I don't think so.
Because I heard from Slughorn that you were asking about the Chamber of Secrets. A lot of people are saying I should kick you out of school.
How dare they speak that way of the Dark King?
That might have something to do with it. All this dark magic stuff. This little club of yours that follows you around. What's it called?
The He-Man Woman Haters. But we're thinking about changing the name.
You're creeping people out, Tom.
What?
I know you've got a lot of fifth-year angst going on, but we've got to get to the root of what makes you so unhappy.
I don't like this.
But you don't ever talk about your feelings.
Well, I do to my journal. But that's top secret.
Well, just pretend I'm your journal for a second. What fills you with so much rage?
Well, I hate all the normal things. Muggles, mudbloods, the Ghostbusters, Well, there's some weird things, too. Things like Snickers.
Oh, you mean when people laugh at you?
No, I like to make people laugh. What I hate is Snickers. You know, the bar.
The candy bar?
Yeah.
The chocolate treat?
Yes. Snickers.
Wait, you don't like chocolate?
Of course I like chocolate.
Wait, you don't like nuts?
Oh, I love nuts.
Wait, then what don't you like?
I don't like Snickers!
Listen, Tom, I think I know exactly what you're going through.
I don't think you do.
You feel anxious and confused. You have funny thoughts about your guy friends that upset you.
What?
So you take it out on the rest of the world. My family never really accepted
me.
Yeah,
well, at least you had a family.
There, Tom. There. How were you ever supposed to learn how to love when you had nobody there to teach you? Well, I've got good news for you, Tom. I'm suspending you.
But that's not good news.
I'm suspending you so you can take a little vacation to Little Hangyton. You're going to spend this Christmas with a very special family there, the Riddles.
What?
I found your dad, Tom. His name is Tom, too. Tom Riddle Sr.
Tom Riddle Sr.? But that makes me Tom Riddle Jr. Little Tommy Jr.
He lives with your grandmother and your grandfather.
Oh, what kind of wizards are they? I always dreamed that my daddy would be something incredible, like a fiend firefighter, or a magical astronaut, or a ballerina.
Tom, it doesn't matter what kind of wizards they are. If you want them to accept you, you have got to accept them.
You're right. I'll accept them whatever kind of wizards they are. Just so long as they are wizards.
So pack your bags, boy, because you're leaving right away.
Wait, but I can't leave now. I've got a club meeting with my slaves. We're voting on a new name.
Oh, forget the name. Now is your chance to find a new path. Maybe you're not supposed to live your life consumed by darkness.
But that's all I know.
Well, it's time to get out there and learn something new. Something you can't learn in a classroom. Tom, it's time to go home.
You're right. You're right!
Hey, good luck, boy. You know, there are only a couple of things in life that I love. And one of them is you.
Thanks, Dumbledore.
When you ask go all the way home just to find what you need and know what to be when you have to go all the way home just to find who you are and know your own heart singing na 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 na.
Tom! My king, you can't leave. You're going to miss the meeting.
Where are you going?
I'm going home.
When you have to go
all the way home.
All the way home. Yeah! You got to go home. You got to go home.
Scene 7. Lights up on nearly headless Nick.
Welcome! Welcome, one and all, to my death day party. This Hallows Eve marks my 506th death day. It's going to be a night to remember. So, grab a drink, enjoy the music. Hello, Mr. Weasley.
Oh, hey, Nick. Happy death day.
You look glum, Mr. Weasley. What ails you?
Well, Hermione really wanted to come to your death day party because she thought it would be intellectually stimulating, so I told her we could make a date out of it, but she didn't show.
Oh, Ron. Why don't you talk to some of the other girls? Just don't talk to the gray lady, okay? I'm trying to get up enough nerve to buy her a drink.
You should go for it.
By golly, you're right. I should. No, I'll do it next year. I'll be fine so long as she doesn't make out with that bastard, the Headless Horseman.
Well, thank you, Harry Potter. Bless your heart.
No problem.
Hey, Joe, I'll be waiting right over here for you all night. Okay. And you look really pretty, by the way.
Oh, bless your heart, Lavender. But you don't have to lie to me. I know I look awful. Just off.
Oh, Joe, you're like the prettiest girl ever.
Want to sit down?
Sure. Bye, Lavender. Well, thank you for taking me out, Harry. Although, I know I must not be very fun to be around. I know I'm boring. Real boring.
You're fine.
No, you're just saying that to make me feel better. You know, when I was dating Cedric Diggory, he always used to say real nice things to me. But he was probably lying, too. I know I'm ugly and boring.
You're fine.
Okay, well, you know what? I'm just going to go to the bathroom. I'm going to powder my nose. My face is probably all oily and splotchy, ain't it?
You're fine, okay?
Okay, well, I'll just be right back in just a moment.
Hey there, good buddy. How you doing?
Ron, Cho Chang sucks. All she does is just fish for compliments. It's the most annoying thing a girl can do, you know? When me and Ginny dated, we'd stay up all night talking about my fame and my fortune and how busy I always am. Why can't Cho do that?
Maybe when you were dating Ginny, you kind of took her for granted.
A ladies first.
Right this way, Miss Weasley.
Oh, thank you, boys.
Wait a second. What is that Ginny on a date with Seamus and Dean?
I'll take care of this. I got this.
Oh, Harry, I'm back. Although I probably still look ugly, don't I?
You're fine. Let's just grab a drink.
Oh, okay. Oh, you guys. Thanks for taking me to nearly Dick's death day party. This is the best day of the...
Come to me, Snave. Now is the time.
I have to go to the bathroom now.
That's cool. We'll be here.
All right, Dean, so here's how this is gonna work. We is gonna wine and dine this, honey.
Yeah, all right.
We is gonna get her heart and mad bubbles.
Yeah,
we is gonna make her fall in love with us.
Yeah.
And then you'll snog her.
Ha! Sounds like a plan to me.
Hey, quit trying to snog my girlfriend.
Say what?
Yeah, bug off, Potter.
She ain't your girlfriend no more, HP.
You stay out of the shame, Dean. Look, bro, don't play me like this. I would never do this to you. Remember all those times that we...
Hey, Ron.
Oh. Hey there, Lavender Brown.
So, I was wondering if maybe we could go out for a bite to eat and we could just...
What?
Back to my place and then maybe we could get a drink together. Yeah, I don't know, we could go out.
What did you say to me? I can't hear you. What? Oh, no. I cheated on my girlfriend. I did it. I'm nothing but a no-good, low-down, rotten, fat, ugly, cheating scumbag. I better go tell Hermione.
No! You stay with me. We're dating now.
No, Lavender Brown. We need to talk about our relationship.
Why?
I don't know if things are gonna work out. This night doesn't seem to be working out for anyone. Oh well, I won't let that get me down. I'm going to go and buy the Grey Lady a drink. What? Horseman, you bastard! You knew I liked the Grey Lady. Horseman, what do you have to say for yourself? Nothing, just as I thought. You coward! Way to ruin it, Grey Lady!
That's how I saved the school and the world. Remember that?
You know what, HP? You did us a solid when you saved a school from all those times. But Ginny is not your property!
But that's not fair!
Well, I can see I'm just getting in your way. Stupid me thinking that someone as ugly as me could have fun on a date with Harry Potter.
Bullocks! Your face shines brighter than Dumbledore's Patronus, it does!
Joe, stop fishing for compliments, okay? Nobody cares. We're trying to talk, so just shut up.
Oh, you best check yourself, HP. Now I see why Ginny dumped your ass.
No, I dumped her ass, D. You know what? We got beef.
Yeah.
We got beef. We got beef.
You can't have beef with D. Now we got beef, Paul. Yeah, we got beef.
Nobody talks to me like that. We've got beef, Harry. We've got beef. Now, take this. So we're on a break now?
You are always like this.
Oh, well, then just call it quits, Ron Weasley. Take this.
That's it. You're going to face me in a duel, sir. Hey, go.
Oh, this looks like a fine spot for my roller skate.
Happy birthday. Hope you like banana cream.
And this looks like a fine spot for my marbles.
I finally finished the ice sculpture. Whoa! The ice sculpture!
Harry!
Great job, Potter. You ruined the Death Day party.
Thanks, Harry!
No, but I was...
Come on, y'all. Let's get out of here.
Are you okay, pal?
Don't touch me.
Hey, guys. Sorry I'm late.
Hermione!
I've just been so busy with all these extra credit essays I'm doing for Gilderoy Lockhart.
Well, freaking well. If it isn't Hermione Stranger, or should I say Hermione the Traitor, you didn't do my potions essay. Because of that, I had to do it. So it never got done. And I failed. Your plan to ruin my life is working out pretty nicely.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, you're sorry. You're a sorry excuse for a friend.
You know what, Harry? You need to calm down. You're acting way too angsty for your age, and this is just like how you were in fifth year. You know, when that
Hermione's voice is drowned out as the lights change, and we hear the echoing, mysterious voice yet again.
Snake. I'm a snake. I'm huge. A huge snake. I'm a ton bigger than you'd expect. You can make like 1,000 shoes out of me, or 1,000,000 little purses. Or 2 really big boots or something, snake.
Hermione, quiet down just for a second. Do you guys hear that?
Hear what?
It's that voice again.
Oh shit, I think that kid hears me. I better get back to the Chamber of Secrets.
Chamber of Secrets? Come on guys, we gotta follow that voice.
I didn't hear anything. Yeah, what voice, Harry? Oh no! Huh. It's nearly Headless Nick and he's petrified.
Ginny, what's going on?
What?
What happened?
I don't know!
What do you mean you don't? don't know. You're standing right there. Some help you are. Why don't you go snog Dean or something?
Fine. Maybe I will.
Whatever.
Harry, what are you looking for?
I heard a voice back there. The same voice I heard before Colin Creepy was petrified. I think it was the Chamber of Secrets monster. Just look for a clue or something. I don't know. Did you find anything, Ron?
No, nothing. Just an endless parade of spiders leaving the castle.
Good riddance. Damn spiders. I hate spiders. Wait! Maybe one of those spiders saw what happened down there. Damn it! If I only had the power to talk to spiders instead of the useless ability to talk to snakes that I never use. Come on, let's follow them.
But Harry, I'm afraid of bugs. And it looks like they're heading for the Forbidden Forest.
They could lead us to the monster. I have to save the school, or I might as well be dead. Come on.
Oh. Harry, Ron, and Hermione follow the trail into a den or nest.
All right. I think they went this way. Keep up.
I'm frightened, Harry.
Quiet, Hermione. This is it. This is the Chamber of Secrets monster. I can feel it. Usually it takes me all year to solve the mystery. But not this year, no way, man, I'm on fire. The boy who was on fire, that's what they'll call me. Yeah. Did you guys hear that?
The kids huddle together. They can see something moving in the shadows. A spidery noise grows as a large figure closes in on our heroes.
Well, well, well. Three little PYTs have found their way into my humble abode. You must be the ones chasing my children through the forest.
No way, whoever you are! We were chasing some disgusting spiders, not little kids.
Wait a second. We're chasing your children? Does that mean that you're a...
giant spider! The name's Aragog. Welcome to my crib.
Yes! I do have the magical ability to talk to spiders. I'm back!
No, I'm just a spider with the magical ability to talk to humans.
Damn it!
Let's get out of here!
Wait, wait, wait! Where are y'all off to so fast? Make yourselves comfy! Grab a web. Stick around. Hey, please, don't run away from me. Oh no, hey B, I cannot breathe without you inside of me. When I look at you, I think of one thing. I feel embarrassed cause I know it's obscene. I want you, I need you, I'll teach you what it's like to party with me. Yeah, I'm getting hungry, baby. It's time to feed. Get in my mouth. Get into my mouth. Get in my mouth. I know you want to, baby. Get into my mouth. Don't even try and escape me. Look so fine, can't get you out of my mind. So won't you get on into my mouth? Oh no, it's a big bad spider, I'm so scared. Get in my mouth. He's gonna eat me and I'm gonna be so tasty. Oh no, oh no, get in my mouth. My life is over, oh my god, this spider is so cool. I want you, I need you, I'll teach you what it's like to party with me. Baby, it's time to feed. What? Get in my mouth. The lyrics are very simple. Follow along. Get into my mouth. And I want you, baby. Get in my mouth. Come on, quickly. This way, follow me.
Get
into my mouth.
Now I'm going to eat you. There's no one to save you now. You haven't got a friend in the world except my mouth.
They still got one friend left, you bastard!
Oh, Hagrid, you're such a mouth kill. Me and my millions of children are starving. We need to feed.
Now, you know that's not true, Aragog. I just don't let you eat defenseless creatures that don't deserve it. I'll bring some more puppies by in the morning.
Oh, puppies. We love puppies.
Well, if it isn't Harry, Ron, and Hermione, what a sight for sore eyes! Yeah! Now, come on. Let's get out of the spider's nest, and I'll take you to a place you might find a wee bit grosser, actually.
Hagrid leads the kids out of Aragog's nest and into a small shack on the edge of the Hogwarts grounds.
Yep, come on in to Hagrid's hut. Sorry, the place is a bit of a mess. I haven't cleaned up or showered since you were last here, so... But it's not just me, you know. I've added another roommate to the mix. You all remember Fox, the Phoenix? Dumbledore left him to me when I died. Yeah, Fox is a great roommate, keeps to himself, sleeps in the fireplace. Unlike that sleepy dragon over there. Wake up, you bastard! He's fine. Whoa, wait a minute. Harry, where's that clown smile of yours? Why, you're acting like something's wrong.
Something is wrong, Hagrid.
Oh, that's not right. I'll tell you what. You come right over here and sit on old Hagrid's lap. Best seat in the house. Come here. There you go. Now, here's a warning. I'm going to bounce you. There. That feels good, doesn't it? Yeah. Yeah, that feels good. If you have to spit up, just do it right into Hagrid's beard. That's what I always do. Now tell me what's wrong. Harry, what's the matter?
Oh, it's nothing, Hagrid. My life just sucks, that's all, okay? It's like people don't even care that I'm Harry Potter anymore. Neville doesn't even stutter around me anymore. He's acting less like he's got a schlong bottom and more like he's got a big old schlonky dick. I've seen the world like a million times. How could everybody just forget that?
Harry, don't you f***ing talk like that. You might be wee. But you've got a greatness in you! Whether you're flying around on that little broom of yours, or singing a song or two, or maybe reminding us all that we're not alone. Right, for some people, Harry, you're the light at the end of a very dark, lonely, shameful tunnel. You're a hero, Harry, as timeless and unforgettable as the VR Troopers.
Who?
The VR Troopers. What, you never heard of this? They're like three little kid superheroes with these mechanical suits.
How do you mean like Beetleborgs?
Beetleborgs? No. Beetleborgs are shite. I'm talking about, the VR Troopers. They were cool. They had this amazing ability to travel through the power lines or the internet, or, you know, I actually can't quite remember what they did, but my point is, you're like them, cherished for all time.
But Hagrid, all my life I've only been known as the savior of Hogwarts, so what does it mean when I'm not at Hogwarts anymore?
Mm-hmm.
I'm scared.
Yeah, all right. Harry, I was once in the same position as you, a senior, facing down the inevitable end of school and childhood, and I didn't want to let it go.
So what did you do?
I didn't let it go, I never left.
You never left Hogwarts?
Nope. They wanted me to leave, but I refused to attend graduation. I'm technically still a student. But when you love something so much,
and you see it slipping through your fingers, Harry, you just got to hold on tighter.
You're hurting me, Harry.
Oh, Harry, sorry. My advice to you is never change. It's fun living at Hogwarts. Sure, all your friends will grow up and start families of their own. But eventually their kids will come to Hogwarts. And, you know, it'll be sad. So sad to see them. You'll probably just sit down in your hut most days watching Netflix or Hulu Plus. Waiting for those three rosy-cheeked little angels to come down for a visit. Maybe ask for a dance lesson or advice. Soon they'll grow up too, and they won't come around as much anymore. And you'll wonder why you keep going. Before you know it, your only company is a dragon that's been asleep for 5 years. And a phoenix, which just reminds you how short life is. But we don't get second chances like that phoenix, do we, kids? No. Once we've burned, we're toast. Well, pep talk's over. Thanks for coming down to cheer me up.
Thanks, Hagrid. This has been fun.
We'd better get back to the dorms.
Well, wait, you don't have to go yet.
Haha, bye, Hagrid. Hagrid always has the best advice. Well, Harry, we didn't quite find the Chamber of Secrets monster, but do you at least feel a little bit better?
No, like, hardly at all. No, not at all. I feel terrible.
Lights up on Ginny in the Gryffindor girls' dorm.
Oh, diary. That date was a total bust. I don't even remember most of it. And then I saw Harry again, and he yelled at me. Oh, diary, do things ever turn out the way you want them to? Show me in another magic flashback.
Lights up on Tom Riddle, who sits in a bedroom of the Riddle house.
Dear Diary Journal, I feel great. I haven't killed or maimed or tortured anything ever since I got to Little Hangleton, and, well, that's kind of a big deal for me. I've just been hanging out with Grandma and Grandpa. And tonight, well, tonight could be the most important night of my life. Tonight I meet my father, and I just know that, well, he's gonna love me. It's strange not hating everything that you see anymore. I've got a new feeling in my chest. I don't even know what it is. But I think that it might be something really special. Well, diary, wish me luck.
Tom puts his diary away and heads downstairs, where he finds his grandfather, Tom's Riddle.
Hey, boy!
Hey, Grandpa!
Come here. Pull my finger.
Okay. Wait. Why?
Pull it.
Okay.
No! Oh, you made me pull my pants!
Junior, you didn't pull his finger, did you?
He told me to.
Well, you can't always listen to everything Tom says, Junior. He still thinks he's in the war.
Oh.
Now, you made this mess, and now you got to clean it up.
Well, okay, Grandpa. Let's get you cleaned up. Okay. There you go.
Unbutton my pants. I don't know how.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Hey. Quit looking at my wiener.
I have to. There's poop on it.
No! No! No, you're wiping!
I know. I'm trying to get you all set, Grandpa.
Oh, you wipe, you damn fool. You got a dab. Barry.
Oh. Hey, will you help me?
Oh. John, you're not wiping on his anus, are you?
Nobody told me to dab.
He has an irritated anus, Junior.
Yes.
You could have killed him, you monster. Now I'm on the phone with my sister.
There you go, Grandpa. All set.
I don't know how to do that.
Mom! Mom, I'm home! My day sucked! Who are you?
Don't you recognize me? It's me, little Tommy Jr. Dad, it's your son.
No! No!
Dad, what's wrong? Oh, are you ashamed for abandoning me in that awful orphanage? Well, it's all right. It's water over the dam or under the bridge or wherever you like it.
Hey, Mom! Do I really have to talk to this guy?
Oh, stop your belly aching, Tom. I told you that relationship of yours would come back to bite you in the bum. Now let's all just sit down and enjoy a nice, cordial Christmas dinner.
God, this is the last thing I need.
Come on, right there. Okay. There we go.
So, there. Dad.
What?
I have so many questions, so many things that I've been wondering my entire life. Where do I even start? Okay. What was Mom like?
Oh, well, she was gross. She didn't even have a nose. She looked like you. Only when you don't have a nose, you look like a snake. But she looked like a pig. Have you ever
seen the Ninja Turtles?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, so like Shredder?
Yeah.
He's got like a pet rhino. He's got like a pet warthog.
Bebop.
Yeah, she looked like Bebop. Only Bebop was fit.
Okay, but she was beautiful on the inside. And that's why you loved her so much.
No, I didn't even like her. She just got me drunk one night when I was high. God.
Yeah, but Dad, you must have felt something.
Quit it.
Oh. Oh, don't touch him. He doesn't like to be touched when he has his headphones on. And now that's enough questions about your mother, Junior. I never liked that Miss Piggy character one bit. She was always on the drugs, and she made him go on the drugs, too. Well, what about you, Junior? Do you have a girlfriend?
No, I don't really have time for girls.
Well, why not? What's wrong with you, boy?
Oh, leave him alone, Toms. He's probably just busy with all them sports, big strapping young man like yourself. Well, what sports do you play, Junior?
Well, I kind of play a sport.
Oh.
I dance.
You what?
You know, dance. Tap, jazz, ballet. I'm also really good at dark magic.
God! Quit with the magic already! Your mom was always running around talking about magic! And she's always like, Dumbo Doll! Quit it!
I don't get it. Why didn't you want to talk about magic with Mom?
Because it's not real.
What?
Your stupid mom just thought it was. Because she was on drugs. It was all in the mind. It's like, show me Hogwarts on a map of the United States of America. It doesn't exist.
Yeah, of course you can't find Hogwarts on a map. It's invisible. It's protected by a magic bubble.
God damn it, Junior. What kind of drugs are you on?
I'm not on drugs.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
You're on drugs.
No, I'm not. You're on drugs.
So what? No, I'm pooping again.
Oh, look at all of us. Fighting like this? Look what you did. You ruined Christmas, Junior.
Let's just open our presents and get this whole disaster over with.
Okay, fine. But, and I'm sorry if this sounds crazy, but for a second there, you all just sounded like horrible, disgusting muggles, that's all.
Muggles! Yeah, right. That's what your mom always used to call us. She calls us muggles. God, she's so annoying. It's like the only good thing about you being born
muggles?
Is that you killed her when you came out. And then she stopped calling me. And it's like, what do I gotta do to get you to stop calling me?
Muggles! Muggles! No! Oh, no! Oh, God! No! Tom, control yourself, calm down. Remember what Dumbledore told you. They are your family, after all. If you want them to accept you, you have to accept... Oh, no!
Well, here you go, Junior. I hope you like it. Merry Christmas.
Snickers. Snickers. Snickers.
Well, do you like it or not, you ungrateful little?
You better get out of
here!
Lights up on the Great Hall.
Attention, all the Hogwarts students! The last day of the term has arrived, and it's time for the head boy election. Please report to the Great Hall immediately, as the results ceremony will begin as soon as the final votes have been tallied. How exciting!
All right, Ron, today's the day. I think we should be fine, right? I mean, I can beat Malfoy, can't I?
Oh, you're gonna beat his pants off.
Hey, Neville, Luna, my loyal DA. Did you guys vote for me?
Not exactly. Well, good luck.
Hey guys, I know I've been having trouble. We haven't really been getting along lately, but I can count on your vote, right?
Yeah, don't hold your breath, Pa.
Come on, Jimmy.
Hermione, there you are. You're the best. You're looking good. Listen, did you vote for me, right?
Well...
All right, children, silence! Silence. I just received the voting results, and it's clear to me that some of you did not take this election seriously. In second place, receiving a total of 2 votes, Mr. Draco Malfoy.
Whoa! 2 votes! That's more than I was expecting. Aren't I proud as a peacock?
Take that, Malfoy! 2 votes! Who looks stupid now?
And tying for second place, also with 2 votes, Mr. Harry Potter.
Wait, what? I voted for me.
As did I.
Ron, who did you vote for?
Just wait for it, Harry.
What?
And winning the election in a landslide with 867 votes, Fozzie Bear.
Yay!
I hope you children are proud of yourselves.
Yeah!
I hope you think this is funny. You children had a chance to have your voices heard, and you wasted your vote on that silly bear.
Yeah!
Silence. Now, Fozzie Bear can't very well be our newest head boy.
Boo!
Silence, because Fozzie Bear is a puppet who fancies himself a comedian. And even if he weren't a puppet, he's a bear. I'm sorry, but all votes for Fozzie Bear must be thrown out.
Cool!
Silence! Now, I'm not sure who's behind this prank, but because of your outlandish immaturity, this election has ended in a disastrous draw!
Yay! Yay!
Tisk, tisk, tisk. For shame on you all. I myself took this business very seriously. Why, I voted for Draco Malfoy, as did my brother, Litteroy Gockhart. There's only one way to break this tie, Headmaster. As defense against the dark arts teacher, I suggest a wizard duel.
Gasp!
Yes, a wizard duel. With our darling little Draco in one corner and that toot-tastic stinker Potter in the other. The winner will be head boy and the loser will be just that. A big, fat loser.
A wizard duel? Well, It seems fair, but putting the children in unnecessary danger for sport? Oh dear, what would Dumbledore do?
It's okay, Professor. I'm not scared of Malfoy.
Oh, all right. All right, children, clear these benches. Back away as far as you can.
You know, Goyle, I've been thinking. What does this election really mean to me anyway? Is it worth endangering my friendship with my oldest friend, Harry Potter? What say you, campaign manager?
No.
Well, then it's settled. I shall march over to the headmaster and concede my candidacy.
Malfoy?
Harry, I've done some thinking and I've come to a decision.
And so have I. You better get ready, because I'm going to kick your butt so hard you're going to burp out farts.
Harry, now, I know this green-eyed election monster has gotten the best of us, but let's not forget that we're friends.
No, we're not, Malfoy. Don't you get it? I never was and I never will be your friend. I hate you.
Oh, I see. So it is to be war betwixt us.
All right, boys. I want to see a good, clean duel. Okay, on the count of four. A 1, 2, 3, 4.
Harry Potter, lover of only himself, do you recall the memories we shared? You never once were nice. You never cared at all. Now you will. I'll have you running scared.
Draco Malfoy, you know nothing of my life. All I am is what I do. I cannot let you win. Scottish evil brat, surrender now before I come for you.
At last the lines are drawn into the sand. At last I know exactly where I stand. You may think that I'm on the decline, but tonight of a tale from years ago. If you find yourself, you're doubting all, then take it as a sign that tonight this school is mine. Yes, tonight this school is mine. Yes, tonight this school is mine. Avengers, stop him!
Slipping down the hill. Look into my eyes, you know this is but mine. So tonight this school is mine. Think that now, boy. Tonight this school is mine. Means it was done. Tonight this school is mine. Petrified.
So fast. Shepard Sortier! Yes.
Hey, listen, Snake. I know your life is kind of rough. If I was in your shoes or scales, I wouldn't be so tough. But I can see the girl inside. Oh, babe, you really shine. There you go, Snake. That's a good girl. Yeah, just shh. That's right, just...
The snake dies.
that was?
He talked to a snake is what I saw.
All we done heard was a bunch of hissing.
Yeah.
He's a parcel tongue.
Just like Salazar Slytherin.
Oh, dear.
Oh, my. What if Harry Potter is the heir of Slytherin?
Gasp.
That's ridiculous.
That would mean that Harry was the one opening the Chamber of Secrets.
It would make sense, wouldn't it? What, Potter, were you so desperate for attention? You just need to be the main character of everyone's life, don't you? But no mystery to solve this year. So you decided to make one. Open the chamber, petrify students all year, and then save the day at the last minute, and everyone will cheer you like you're some sort of hero?
No, that's not what's happening! You guys believe me, right? Fina, Luna?
Take a look around, boy. Get it through that thick skull of yours. Nobody likes Harry Potter anymore. Whatever spell you've had over the world has faded. We've all moved on. So why haven't you?
I'm out of here!
Harry, wait!
Well, I guess by exiting the dueling arena, Potter has forfeit. That means the winner and newest Hogwarts head boy is none other than Draco Malfoy.
Thank you, Professor. Draco Malfoy shall rule over this school with peace and love for 1,000 years. But first comes a time of swift retribution, for I shall rain down a vengeance upon all those who have teased me in the past. Welcome to my nightmare, slaves. The age of Harry Potter has ended. The reign of Draco Malfoy has begun!
Harry runs out of the Great Hall into the hallways of Hogwarts.
Harry, wait!
What do you want?
To talk about the diary you gave me. Tom's diary. Harry, we need your help.
Oh, yeah, like you helped me in the Great Hall? You didn't even try to stick up for me. You just sat there with Seamus and Dean. Tell them about your diary. I'm done helping people. Never again.
Harry, you may not be popular anymore, but people still need your help. You're Harry Potter.
No, I'm not, okay? At least not anymore. Everything that made me who I am is gone. I was Harry Potter.
There was a time when life had meaning, not so long ago.
I knew the light, it was easy being the star of the show. There was a time when things were fine, I could make wine from butter.
There was a time when I was happy, when I was Harry Potter.
Tom, I think I understand you now. You can't put your faith in anyone anymore. The world is a terrible, lonely place. I'm ready to see what happened to you after you killed your father.
There was a time when I was hopeful, when I was good inside. Everyone said that I was evil. Maybe they were right. I changed my name, I went insane. I've never felt so little. I was a fool to think they could love me when I was Thomas Riddle. I've fallen from up high. The world has said goodbye. I'm not an angel, not the answer. I'm just going nowhere faster.
There was a time I was a hero, but that hero's gone. Looking back, I can hardly see him. Everyone's moved on.
Cast me aside, throw me away. go on, forget yesterday, and I'll try forgetting too. But I wish it was just like it was before. I wish it was just like it was before.
Harry, where are you going?
Away from here.
No, don't say that, Harry. Let's go back to the Great Hall and we'll try to explain things.
I'm not gonna go back to the Great Hall. Don't you understand, Hermione? I'm never gonna go back. I'm leaving Hogwarts forever. You saw what happened back there. Nobody wants me here. And you know what? I don't blame them. Who would care about a loser like me?
Losers like us? That's who?
Harry. Hogwarts is your home, Harry.
It used to be. Bye.
From up high, the world has said goodbye. I'm not an angel, not the answer. How did life become one disaster? I'm just going nowhere faster. There was a time before I was adored by every son and daughter. There was a time when I was happy, when I was Harry Potter.
And so I left Hogwarts, never to return. For years I wandered, mastering the dark arts, becoming something all would come to fear. And now, tonight, I call on the wizards and witches who entered my service long ago. Now we will know who will be brave enough to return and who will be foolish enough to stay away. Tonight, I begin my war on this world. Tom Riddle is no more. I am Lord Voldemort! No, Ginny. I'm back. I'm not dead, nor am I alive. Yet. Don't try to stop me, Ginny. You haven't got any choice in the matter anymore. I've become far too strong to resist. Now, my slave to the Chamber of Secrets. Come, my basilisk. Snake! Ah. Yeah! Yeah! For far too long you fed on mere vermin, but you will have final prey. Lord Voldemort shall provide.
What's all the hub? Oh, am I not another one?
Oh, dear me, it's Hannah Abbott. Poor thing, she's been petrified. Just like the others. How many is that now, Headmaster?
341. I'll have to send word to the Ministry. The fate of the school is in their hands now.
Well, take Miss Abbott to the infirmary. Spitzbot. Attention, Hogwarts students. Hogwarts is no longer safe. There has been yet another petrification, putting us over the allowed limit of 340 student casualties each school year. As a result, new safety regulations must be implemented immediately. Students shall henceforth report directly to class from their dormitories. All lollygagging privileges are dismissed until further notice. Beware, children. Unless the chamber is found and the monster inside destroyed, the ministry may close the school forever. Wizard God, help us all.
Close Hogwarts? Forever?
Oh, dear.
You know, I heard all this wouldn't be a problem if the school's entire supply of mandrakes didn't get destroyed when somebody mucked up the herbology room.
Yeah, and it's too bad those were the last mandrakes in the whole world. You know, mandrake juice is the only thing that can cure being petrified.
Or if somebody kills the Chamber of Secrets monster, that would break the petrification spell.
Yeah, but who's gonna do that, Loony?
You know whose fault all this is? Harry Potter's. I heard it was him that wrecked the greenhouse. The school just blamed it on some Latina chick, cause they're racist!
True.
It was actually Harry that did it, and probably on purpose so as no one else could save the school. Bloody Derby couldn't handle not being the hero for once. Well, where are you now, Harry Potter? Where are you now?
Shame on you.
Huh?
I said shame on you, Seamus. Shame on all of you. Look at yourselves, sitting around, complaining, spreading gossip. Harry didn't destroy the herbology room. It was like that when he got there. Do you guys want to know why Harry always saves the school? Because he doesn't wait around for someone else to do it. Do you remember our fourth year when Igor Karkaroff was bewitching exchange students, making them compete in the Triwizard Tournament, not to be confused with the House Cup Tournament? Who was it that unmasked Karkaroff as a Death Eater and sent him to Azkaban?
Harry.
And Cho, what did you do that year?
I fooled around with Victor Krum.
Me too.
Yeah, me too. Shooting marbles, tag, ordering all them pizzas to Filch's office. We did some right fooling around that year.
Yeah, and remember our fifth year when Umbridge became the Minister of Magic and appointed those incestuous Karo twins as the dark arts teachers? Luna, what did you do when the Karos told you to shoot the Cruciatus curse at Neville?
Asked if I could try the killing curse?
Mm-hmm. And who was the only one of us who didn't raise his wand against a fellow student?
Harry.
And when the Karos tried to torture the location of the DA out of Cho, who tricked them into walking through Devil's Snare where they were torn asunder?
Harry.
And then united the Giants against Umbridge's evil ministry. Who was that?
Harry.
That's right, Harry. And how do we repay him, huh? Tell him he stinks. We drive him away. Well, the school's in bigger trouble than ever now, and I hope you're all proud of yourselves, because the only person standing between you and whatever's in that Chamber of Secrets is your new head boy, Malfoy.
Well. If it isn't the ignorant mob that handed me supreme power. They all look so tiny from up here, don't they, Goyle?
Yes, me lord.
All right. The head boy, Draco Malfoy, will now hear your questions, concerns, praise, worship.
None of that sounded like worship. So what's your plan to save the school, Malfoy? For dealing with this Chamber of Secrets thing?
Plan? What do you mean, plan? I already have a four-step plan in place. One, watch mudbloods get petrified. Two, laugh, repeat. And I promise that my administration will do all it can to ensure we aid this heir of Slytherin hero. Draco Malfoy will bring change you can believe in.
Boo!
Silence! Silence, you worms! God, I wish you had one neck I'd hack it through! Now, I may not be as deft a politician as that fuzzy bear, but I think we can all agree that I fill the position much better than that Harry Potter ever would.
That's not true, Malfoy. Your rule is a pathetic sham.
Silence yourself, Weasley. Why don't you stop wasting my time and go cry to one of your two girlfriends?
Gasp!
Ron? Girlfriends?
Oh. What? Didn't he fess up? Don't you know? Or is he a liar, as well as a fat, ugly, cheating scumbag?
It's true, Hermione. Lavender and I choreographed an affair behind your back. I'm so sorry. I tried to tell you so many times, but, well, I tried to tell you one time, and then I lied so you wouldn't break up with me. Oh my God, could you please not break up with me?
Ron, I have been working so hard all year writing these essays for Gilderoy Lockhart, working on my future, on our future.
Our future? Where you're just bored with me and you won't kiss me? Where you're so busy with those crappy adult novels? Ugh, I hate Gilderoy Lockhart.
Ron, don't you remember how the scarf of sexual preference sorted me? Waiting for marriage. And I thought you understood that. I'm sorry if I wanted our next kiss to be our wedding day. I don't think I'd better be around you anymore.
But I...
Just go!
Tut, tut, tut. What a shame. No, Miss Granger. I know how it feels to be betrayed by someone you love. When I found Paddington Bear's big floppy hat in mine and Dora's crib, well, it tore me apart. But I just want you to know, if you ever want someone to talk to or just have comforting sex with, you can always come to me.
In your dreams, Malfoy!
Filthy mudblood! You could have joined me up here, Granger, if only you had the courage. Candy Lady, to potions class. Show me the meaning of haste.
Hey, Herman.
Hey, Cho.
Looks like you could use some head girl advice right about now.
Okay.
Well, you want to know what I would do? I would find someone that Ron really hates, and I would re-cheat that little scrub for the win. Okay, girl, now go get him.
Re-cheat Ron? Well, who does Ron hate more than anybody else in the whole world, other than Malfoy?
Miss Hermione Granger! Oh, there you are. Professor Gilderoy Lockhart requests your presence in his office immediately.
Scene 3. Lights up on the headmaster's office. The place is in shambles. Poor Ginny holds the diary in one hand and rips through drawers and cabinets with the other. Voldemort looks up at a portrait of Hogwarts' former headmaster, Albus Dumbledore.
Ah! Dumbledore! You old fool! I know that you hid the Resurrection Stone in here somewhere, and I'm gonna find it! Keep looking, Snave!
Ginny, what is going on?
Oh, shit! Get rid of her! Get rid of her! Oh. That's right, I forgot. She can't see me unless she touches the notebook. Just the same rules as Death Note. They sure are. Anyway, I just thought I'd say that out loud for your benefit. Or anyone's, really. The hell are you looking at me for? I said get rid of her!
Ginny, destroying the headmaster's office is definitely against the rules. You know what? You've been acting like a real rule breaker ever since you got your hands on that diary.
General.
Wait a second. I remember. The Death Eaters were after that thing for some reason. You know what, Ginny? I think you'd better let me hold on to that. Give me the diary, you spaz. Oh! Oh! Akio Diary.
Whoa.
Tom Marvallo Riddle. Wait a second. If I take this letter and I put it there and I take that letter and it it reads, am I Lord Voldemort?
No, I am Lord Voldemort.
No. No, you're dead.
Nope.
But Harry killed you. Dumbledore destroyed all the Horcruxes.
Ah, Dumbledore only thought he destroyed all of the Horcruxes, but he missed one that was hidden until now.
The diary.
That's right, the journal.
That means that you're the heir of Slytherin. You're the one who's been letting out the Chamber of Secrets monster.
Yeah.
So why are you petrifying everyone?
You mean, besides for the fun of it? Well, I hate to break it to you, but it's a red herring to keep you idiots distracted while I search for the real prize, the Resurrection Stone. And once I find it, I'll be back, and there's nobody left who can stop me. Now the bitch is back, and there's hell to pay. You do realize, now that I've completely divulged my evil plan, you have to be silenced.
Are you gonna kill me?
Nope! I think I'll just keep you on ice. Save you for later. Snave! Summon my giant snake. Oh. And Hermione? I'd run if I were you. Get!
To anyone who finds this note, destroy the diary!
Scene 4. Lights up on the infirmary of Hogwarts.
Madame Pomfrey!
Oh, Ronald, there you are.
I just got your telegram. What's up?
Ronald, it's Hermione.
Oh, no. Hermione! What happened to her, Doc?
Well, I'm afraid she's been petrified, like all the other students. And I'm afraid if we don't stop this monster, she won't have much time left.
Oh, Hermione. I don't know if you could hear me in there. I'm so sorry. I've been such a lousy boyfriend, and I should be in that cot, not you. It's not fair. It's not fair. I didn't know I wasn't there. It's not fair. It's not fair. Seeing you lying there. I wasn't strong enough to save you from the evil stuff. I wasn't smart like you to do what you would do. I know I'm not a leading man. I know I'm not a star. But I know what makes me special is what I feel in my heart. I'm just a sidekick, but I love being at your side. I've been in the shadows for far too long, but I'm the leading man of this song. I was a stupid doofus, but now that's gone. I'm ready for a change, gonna keep calm and carry on. I'm not a pretty boy, but I'm a man. I'll find a way to save you, baby, yes I can. Don't confuse the way I was with the way I am. I'm ready for a change, gonna take a stand. I'm just a sidekick. Oh yeah, I'm just a sidekick. Oh yeah, I'm just a sidekick. But I love being
at your side. I'm always forgotten, always come in second place. I'll never be the front man, no one can remember my face. If I was in a dinner, I would surely be the less prominent taste. But when I think of how I feel for you and the love I have inside, I forget all about all the things I've got, and my heart fills up with pride. Am I the strongest? No, I'm not. Am I the smartest? No, I'm not. Am I the hottest? No, I'm not. But am I the greatest? No, I'm not. Am I the hero? No, I'm not. Am I the one who steals the show? No, I'm not. Am I the one that you should know? No, I'm not. But am I the one who takes you home? Definitely not. Am I the chosen one? No, I'm not. Am I the prodigal son? No, I'm not. Am I almost done? No, I'm not. But I'm the one who's gonna love you with all of his heart, because that's what I've got. I'm the one who's gonna love you with all of his heart, because that's what I've got. I'm not a great athlete, I'm no good at art. I know my brains by now, my most impressive art. My wand can barely work and my car won't start. But I know what makes me special, what I feel in my heart. I'm just a sidekick. Oh, I'm just a sidekick. Yeah, I'm just a sidekick. But I love, I love, I love being at your side.
Huh? What's this? Whoever's reading this, the Chamber of Secrets is being opened by Lord Voldemort. He's back. He's the heir of Slytherin. You have to find one final Horcrux. Destroy the diary? Oh, shit!
Madame Pomfrey! Madame Pomfrey! I came as soon as I received your telegram. Madame Pomfrey! Where is she? Where's him? Hermione? Oh, no.
This is all your fault, Draco. You're the head boy. And you're supposed to be doing something, but you didn't do anything to find out who was opening the Chamber of Secrets.
Not now. Pointing fingers won't solve anything, no matter how true it may be.
Yeah, well, Hermione figured it out. It's Voldemort. He's back. He's the heir of Slytherin. So why don't you just get out of here? You're the last person I want to talk to right now.
Wait! Just hear me out, okay? I know we haven't always gotten along. I hate you because you have everything I want, and you don't deserve any of it.
I agree. And I hate you because somebody told me to.
But I think despite our differences, we can agree on one thing. Neither of us wanted this to happen to Hermione.
Okay, so what do you suppose we do about it?
Us? There's very little we can do about it. You and I are the two stupidest people I know. But together, we might be able to be smart enough to find someone who is smart enough to save the school.
You're right. And there's only, if we're dealing with Voldemort, there's only one guy we could turn to. The one guy who has the power to make the impossible possible. We gotta find Harry Potter. We gotta bring him back. He's the savior of Hogwarts. That's his thing. Where are we gonna find him? I mean, to find him, it would take literally all the luck in the world.
Luck, eh? Well, we could always use this. It's Felix Felicis, the most powerful good luck potion in the world. I got it from Professor Slughorn before he got busted for collecting young boys.
Whoa, 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 you've had Felix Felicis this whole time and you haven't used it.
Of course I've used it, Weasley. How do you think I got those 2 votes in the head boy election?
Well, hand it over.
Not so fast. We haven't discussed the subject of payment.
Payment? Malfoy, you butthead. Isn't saving the school payment enough?
Nope. I want something else. What I've always wanted, really. If you and I are able to save the school and keep Hermione from dying, then we both get to date her.
Ah!
Or I could just drink the last of this Felix Felicis and hit the penny arcade.
All right. You win, Malfoy. I guess sharing Hermione is better than burying her.
Excellent. Okay, Weasley. Here's half of what's left. Now, when you drink that, you'll have better luck than you've ever had before, but the effects are temporary. They won't last long.
Okay, well, you gotta go find the Chamber of Secrets, because when I bring Harry back, you're gonna need to show us where it is so we can solve this mystery once and for all.
Got it. Well, good luck, my man.
Bottoms up. Whoa. This feels groovy, baby.
Yes, the Chamber of Secrets will do. Right after I use the bathroom. The prefix bathroom, no wait. Filch has the boys' clothes for repairs. Oh, I'll just use the girls' bathroom. Oh, suddenly I have the urge to hiss at the graffiti of a snake.
Okay, Ron, first things first. You gotta find transportation. Gotta get a broom, or learn how to apparate real quickly. Ah, too bad that flying car drove off in the beginning of the year.
Beep, 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 beep. Suddenly the flying car appears and pulls up next to Ron.
The flying car! Now, quick, let's blow this.
Suddenly the flying car's door swings open, hitting Ron in the face. Gilderoy Lockhart emerges from the driver's seat.
Where are you off to in such a hurry, Sneasley?
Hey! What luck! An adult! Maybe you can help me. I'm looking for Harry Potter.
Oh, I know exactly where to find Harry Potter.
You do?
Of course I do. You can find Harry in your neighborhood bookstore this fall, motherfucker.
What the hell is that?
This, my dear boy, is a young adult novel. My latest work, Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. Catchy title, wouldn't you say?
The Sorcerer's Stone? Do you mean the Philosopher's Stone? That stupid piece of crap Draco found on Pittsburgh?
Yes. I thought it was safer to call it the Sorcerer's Stone, so it's very clear this is a book about wizards.
Wait, what? Why would anyone reading a book about Harry Potter not know that it's a book about wizards?
Because this book isn't for wizards, you meddlesome ass. It's for muggles.
Muggles? Muggles don't know anything about Harry.
Which makes them the perfect market. Beautiful, isn't it? In our world, Harry's story is common knowledge, but to muggles, Harry Potter is brand new. In fact, it's the cash cow franchise of the decade. You see, I've been pulling this little scam for a while now. I go to the muggle world, I find a popular book series, I bring it to the wizarding world, slap my name on it, and sell it to idiot wizards. But this time, I decided to do the same thing, but different. Take a wizard story and sell it to muggles. So I conned some stupid troll into writing this schlock for me, and alakazam! Every 11-year-old in the world will be wishing they were Harry Potter.
No, Mr. Lockhart, if you sell Harry's story to the muggles, you'll expose all the wizards. That'll be like taking our whole world and
f***ing it in the face. Yeah, that's the idea. I'm going to make these books huge. Then the real fun begins. Do you have any idea how much money I'm going to make off merchandise alone? The Severus Snape beach towel. The Hermione Granger toothbrush. How about a real wand, you little muggle bastards? Well, guess what, kiddies? They're just resin. And boy, howdy, do they break like f***ing twigs. T-shirts, bed sheets, video games, action figures, and in time, a theme park.
A theme park in sunny Orlando, Florida. $85 a head. How about a real butter beer? It's just cream soda, you f***ing idiots! I'm going to squeeze the Harry Potter franchise for every last red cent. And when I'm through, once I have all that money, I'm going to shrink myself to the size of a f***ing mouse.
You're mad, Gilderoy.
I've worked too hard to drive Potter away, that stinker. Who do you think made all those buttons? I'm not letting you stop me now. I'm not letting you bring him back.
Well, then you'll have to kill me, because I'll do anything to bring Harry back.
Oh, no, you won't, Sneasley. I happen to be quite adept at memory charms. After I'm done with you, you won't remember anything about Harry Potter. But don't worry, you can read all about him and his friends for just $29.99. Say goodbye to your memories. Oblivion!
Freeze, motherfucker, with a wizard cap!
No!
On the ground! On the ground!
You'll never take me alive!
Fire!
Reducio!
He got away. For now.
Damn!
According to our ministry files, Gilderoy's got a time turner stashed away somewhere. I sure he don't do nothing with those twisted Harry Potter books.
Kingsley Shacklebolt.
You sure are lucky, Ronald Weasley. The wizard cops had just got to Hogwarts when our man on the inside told us you might be in trouble.
What? Who's your man on the inside?
Hagrid, that's it. I've been working with the wizard cops all year, keeping an eye on you lot. And I think it just paid off. So what do you say, Kingsley? Can I please be a wizard cop for real?
We'll see about that, Hagrid. Junior deputy.
Gasp!
Hagrid, welcome to the wizard cops.
Word!
Oh, this is a dream come true. Thank you so much.
Now let's do the job we actually came here to do. Get the kids out of their dormitories and into the courtyard.
Why?
We're evacuating Hogwarts. The school's not safe anymore. Kids getting petrified, monsters on the loose. The whole wizarding world could be in danger. The ministry has made its decision. We're getting everyone out, and we're destroying the castle.
No!
This is the end of the line. In about 30 minutes, the Wizard Air Force will be here, and they'll be blowing up Hogwarts.
Mr. Shacklebolt, you gotta wait. We can still save it.
Back off, Ron. I got a job to do. Hagrid, keep an eye on him. And if you or any of Dumbledore's army tries to get in my way, I'll take it down myself. I'm sorry. It's for your own good.
Attention all Hogwarts students! This is an emergency. Please exit the castle and prepare to operate off school grounds. This is not a drill!
No. No.
Psst. Ron! Ron, come here. I'm putting my badge on the line here, but I don't care anymore. Get in that flying car, and you go find your buddy, Harry Potter. You need to bring him back. We can't let them destroy Hogwarts.
If only Harry hadn't left. If only you hadn't scared him with that stupid pep talk.
Ron, I told Harry exactly what he needed to hear. This may come as a surprise to you, but I'm not a very happy person. I didn't want Harry to end up like me. Because when you get old and fat, like Hagrid, you realize that it's not school you miss. It's being young and skinny and physically able to have sex. And that's what I wanted for Harry. The end of school is just the beginning of your tiny lives. Now, you've got to think, Ron. Where would Harry go if he had nowhere else left in the world?
I think I know.
Well, then what are you waiting for? Get going, Sonny!
Goodbye, Hagrid. I'm gonna bring Harry back, or I'm gonna die trying. Hey, Hagrid.
Huh?
Do you mind giving us a fastball special?
You got it!
Yeah! Ron flies off into the night in the flying car.
Scene 5. Harry enters the village square of Godric's Hollow. In the middle of the square stands a huge statue of Harry.
Well, here I am, Godric's Hollow. The place of my birth, the one place in this wretched world where I'm remembered for all time. Ah, look at you. You're not going anywhere anytime soon, are you, buddy?
All right, let her rip!
A wrecking ball flies into the stage, smashing the Harry Potter statue into a million pieces.
What'd you tear that statue down for?
What? That old eyesore? The shitty's been getting too many complaints about that thing. We had to make room for this, a new statue of Spider-Man!
Well, if I'm being replaced by Spider-Man, I guess I can live with that.
Yep, Andrew Garfield, love him.
Wait, what? No, Tobey Maguire.
Oh!
You know, Tobey Maguire, f***ing Spider-Man.
Oh, you mean from those old movies? Yeah, I saw those once. Who was the bad guy in those? That green gremlin guy had the little robot wormies on his back. Could turn into sand. He had the thing on his thing. Yeah, that was pretty cool. You know, they did all of that with computers. Hey, kid, why the long face?
Well, I guess not even the Spider-Man movies are sacred, are they? I thought people would remember those forever. You know what? I take back all those bad things I ever said about Spider-Man 3. Sam Raimi did the best he could, given the circumstances. Studios breathing down his neck, that idiot Avi Arad making him put Venom in it. It's like, Sam did so much good. And in the end, everybody threw him out like he was yesterday's garbage.
Hey, come on, kid. They're just movies. They're not that big of a deal.
Well, if the Spider-Man movies aren't that big of a deal, then what is?
I guess that all depends. Take it from me, a professional monument destroyer and rebuilder. In the late 90s, I was tearing down statues of Batman all over the place. Now I'm building them back up again. You like Tobey Maguire Spider-Man. But this Andrew Garfield Spider-Man is gonna mean a lot to a lot of kids with bad taste. But one day I'll come and tear him down too. If I get the contract, God willing. Things come and go. Nothing lasts forever, kid. And nothing's built to. But what do I know, huh? I'm just your everyday, working class, blue collar, gay guy with a beard. Hey. What about the bulldoze, this whole historic Potter house? You know, this whole Harry Potter craze is about to be over in about 30 minutes, so why don't you go take one last look around?
Thanks.
Hey, no problem, Harry. You know, there's two things in this world that I love. One of them is you.
How'd you... What?
Harry! Harry! Harry!
Ron!
I knew you'd be in Godric's Hollow.
But man, what are you doing here?
I came to get you. Come on, the school's in trouble.
Again?
Big trouble this time. Harry, they're gonna destroy Hogwarts. And that's not the worst of it, Harry. It's Voldemort. He's back. He's the heir of Slytherin.
Voldemort, that's impossible. Just bounce his own killing curse back at him. That usually works.
No. He's got the Chamber of Secrets monster this time, and half the school is petrified.
Well, it sucks for them.
He's got Hermione. Harry, Hermione's petrified, and I can't do anything to help her.
Ron, I can't come with you.
Why? Because you're afraid to fight Voldemort again?
No!
Or because you think no one thinks you're cool? Who cares? You haven't changed. You'll always be cool. Because cool doesn't come from other people. It comes from you. Here. This is yours. Remember what it means? The house of the brave, the house of the good guys. Harry, you got sorted into this house for a reason. I can't go anymore. I need you to end this.
It must be nice having someone to come cry to when you can't do things for yourself.
Yeah, it was nice. Having a friend you could rely on. Harry Potter was my best friend. But you know what? You're not Harry Potter.
That's right.
Well, whoever you are, you don't deserve to be my friend.
The lucky snitch. I open at the close.
You don't know what you're hiding from. How did life become such a sad song?
Death?
You don't know what you're fighting for. What you came here for, feeling all alone.
You have loved.
You have lost. How could this be happening
all alone
on your own?
But you shouldn't give up. But you shouldn't do that. Never ever give up.
No, don't ever do that.
Dad! Sirius Lupin!
Hello, son. Hey, Harry.
What are you guys doing here? I thought you all died.
We did. But you brought us here, Harry.
How?
That thing you hold in your hand. That's what Dumbledore left you. It's called the Resurrection Stone.
It brings people back from the dead?
Not really. It just sort of lets you talk to ghosts.
Hey, but everybody at school can do that.
It's kind of a piece of shit. Oh. I mean poopy.
Nothing can stop death, Harry.
Nothing is made to last. The sun goes up and falls so fast. The clock looks still the hours pass. And all that time is never coming back.
Everything has an end. Even the lives of family and friends. Everything has.
Father and I separated. He's kind of immature, but I found someone new in heaven.
I'd say we found each other.
What the f-? Mom, you're dating Cedric?
Harry, we're not dating, we're married.
Looks like I'm your heavenly father, eh, Potter?
Mom! Mom, it's the stupidest thing you ever done!
Hey! Now, you can talk to me however you like, but when you talk to my woman that way, that's when we're going to have words.
All right. You suck so much, Cedric!
We'll agree to disagree. I'm glad we could find some common ground.
Doing that!
Well, if it isn't broke, don't find a way to fix it.
Man, I hate that guy.
Yes, you're telling me! Harry, Harry! Harry!
Hey!
Harry, dude, what's going on, man? Listen, we've all been looking over you because we think you might need our help. For a while, I really enjoyed your suffering. But now it's just kind of bumming me out. So come on, man, tell me, what's the deal?
Snape, I've lost everything that made me who I am. I lost my fame, my purpose. I'm about to lose Hogwarts. What do I do? How do I make things go back to how they used to be?
That's just it, Harry. You can't.
You can't hold on to what's gone. Don't try to fix it, just move on. Only then you'll see the world all brand new.
Harry, the end comes to us all, but some of us get to choose how we go. Look at me, Harry. I could have helped the Dark Lord take over the world and ruled like a half-blood prince, but instead, I chose to give my life, protecting the last trace of the only woman I've ever loved. Harry, did I do that so people would like me? No, I hate people. Did I do it to be remembered? No, I did it because it was right. You have a choice, Harry. You can run away and hide until you eventually peter out of existence. Or you can go down in one last blaze of glory!
Of my teachers, my mother and my dad. And I know how right they are, and it stings as so I'm lightning scarred. I know I could never, ever mess things up so bad. Now the school's in danger, and my friend Hermione Granger has been petrified. Voldemort's been plotting, but there's one thing he's forgotten. I'm still alive!
time that I've been kicking around. My friends in trouble, so I'm skipping this town. Hey, it's no mystery, it's all so clear to me now. We're totally awesome.
On the came back! Just in the nick of time. I was on my way back to Hogwarts, but then I ran into some guy with a beard and he told me he'd probably change your mind. Then you started singing.
Run! Sorry I forgot who I was, but I remember now. I'm your friend.
Best friend.
Now come on, pal. Rub up that flying car. Let's go.
Let's go, buddy! We don't have long, but we're going back. Don't go for work, don't go there for class.
As long as we're together, gonna kick some ass. And it's gonna be totally awesome. We're seeing summer and there's one way around. It's like sitting in the lost and found. Don't take no source of me or anyone to see how. We gotta get back to Hogwarts. We gotta get back to school. We gotta get back to Hogwarts.
Back at school, Kingsley Shacklebolt and the Wizard Cops are finishing the evacuation of Hogwarts.
Keep moving, kids. Get as far away from the school as you can.
Who would have thought that after all these years it would end like this?
There, there, Scoffy.
Beep, 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 beep.
Did you hear that?
It sounded just like... No, it couldn't be.
There is a whoosh. As the flying car swoops over the kids' heads and flies towards the castle.
Bloody hell! It's Harry Potter!
He's back!
He's back!
He's back!
Well, then there's still a chance that we can save the school, y'all!
Yeah! Yeah!
Come on, y'all!
And just where the hell do you think you kids are going?
We're going to help our friend.
If you step one foot inside that castle, you'll be in direct violation of the Ministry of Magic.
Oi, stuff it, you old geezers!
Come on, yeah! 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 Yeah!
Who knows how fast this is gonna go? Our one last chance is the end of the show. Grab the whole cast, have a look and show.
Secrets. Turns out I was in the girl's bathroom the whole time.
Excellent work, Mr. Malfoy. Harry Potter, You've got to get down there and slay that monster, or else the school and everyone in it will be destroyed. I'll try and stop the Wizard Cop airstrike. Prepare my flying machine!
Alright guys, let's go! Nobody has to come who doesn't want to.
This is our home too, Harry!
We're with ya!
Then it's time to take it back, what do you say?
Back for witches and wizards and magical beasts. Goblins, ghosts, and magical beasts. It's all that I love and it's all that I need at Hogwarts, Hogwarts. Back for spells and enchantments, potions and friends.
To Gryffindor!
Super rare! Back to the place where our story begins at Hogwarts, Hogwarts.
Scene 6. Harry, Ron, Draco, Neville, Luna, Seamus, Dean, Cho, Lavender, and the other kids of Hogwarts stand in a tight group in the girls' bathroom.
There! That picture of the snake! Speak Parseltongue at it and the chamber opens.
Let's do this. Voldemort is going down. Come on!
The door to the Chamber of Secrets clanks open and they step inside. The chamber is dark, wet, and cold.
All right, everyone. Stick together.
Harry Potter, the boy who lived. So, we meet again.
Whoa, is that a flying diary?
Oh, shit.
That's so weird! Shit. I came back to stop you. How many times do I have to kill you, Voldemort?
Clearly more than once, Potter.
You really think you stand a chance? I already beat you, the real you, and all you are right now is a ghost.
Not for long. Soon I'll find the Resurrection Stone, and I'll be back.
You mean this bad boy?
Yeah.
I hate to run in your parade, but it doesn't even work, Voldemort. It only brings back spirits. It doesn't even raise people from the grave. I don't know what you've heard, but it's just a piece of shit.
But it's not a piece of shit. You're a piece of shit. In fact, it does work. Dumbledore just didn't know how to use it. In order to truly regain a life, you have to take it from somebody else. Why, I think I'll use hers!
Ginny, snap out of it! What did you do to her?
I've been possessing her all year. Now she's my slave. And I really should thank you, Harry. In fact, you're the one who gave her to me. She belongs to me now. And once I have that stone, I'll be able to fully steal her life. And then I'll have returned. And her skeleton will lie in this chamber forever.
You're not gonna get this stone, Voldemort. I got a whole school backing me up. This isn't just between you and me.
You're right. This isn't between you and me. It's between you and me and my giant snake!
He's a monster! I'm gonna get you, stupid human. Take this.
Bloody hell! That snake is almost as big as the snake! Ah!
Seamus! He's petrified! Ah!
Don't look at that thing! It'll petrify you if you do! Okay, how do we beat the Chamber of Secrets monster? We can't even look at it!
That creature is called the Basilisk! The sword of Godric Gryffindor is the only thing strong enough to penetrate its scales. Listen, it is said that the truest Gryffindor could pull the sword from within me.
Huh?
Let me try.
How'd the sword get up in you, Swordy?
Well, I may have had something to do with that. Let me try. Nothing.
All right, I'll try.
Nothing. Harry, you're still afraid, still unsure of yourself.
Found ya.
Well, if we want a fighting chance, somebody's gotta go blind that thing. Get out of the way, kids.
Scarfy, why do you have to be so brave?
You're the one that sorted me into Gryffindor. And you're the one that taught this old hat how to love.
Be careful!
I will. Take this, you tacky snake!
Oh, ha! Yeah. Ugh. I can't see. Who turned out the light?
He's blind! Everybody shoot magic at it!
Hey, did you guys come here just to hurt me? I liked it so much better when my chamber was a secret.
Our spells aren't doing anything. His scales are too strong.
Well, at least he can't see us. Everyone be quiet.
Huh? Hey, where'd they go? Marco.
Polo.
Gotcha, sucker!
You!
Well, well, Tom Riddle.
How dare you use that name?
Now, you may have cut your hair, lost your shirt and added a fabulous cape, but you're still that confused little orphan boy from all those years ago.
Shut up!
But you were wrong about the world, Tom. Just like you were wrong about yourself. People did care about you. Dumbledore did. I did. And I think you care about people, too. Deep down. And I think you know it.
Oh, yeah? How's this for caring? Avada Kedavra!
Oh,
Scarlet! No!
Yes. Now give me that stone, Potter. Snake!
Yes, Master. Give it. Hand it over.
You're finished, Potter. You can't stop me. Remember? You've lost everything that made you the Chosen One. Face it. You don't even know who you are.
Oh, yeah? I'm Harry freaking Potter! No.
The basilisk and Harry fall to the ground. The basilisk is dead, but Harry is dying. Voldemort walks to the resurrection stone and picks it up.
At last, you are mine! Oh, Snape! I want the last thing that Harry Potter to see to be me sucking the life out of his girlfriend. Oh, thanks, babe. It's been one crazy year. Ha ha ha! Hey, Harry, tell me, how does it feel knowing that you failed? Knowing that I'm gonna walk out of here and rule the world forever, and knowing that when I do, I'll have wiped every trace of your story from the face of the earth. Nobody will remember you. Nobody will care. While I will live forever, for you, this is your end, Harry Potter.
Well, Voldemort, if Harry Potter can't live forever, then neither can you!
What?
Harry lifts up the sword of Gryffindor and stabs the diary.
No!
Blood begins to spurt from the diary as Voldemort convulses. Voldemort Voldemort's chest explodes open. A blinding white light shines out. Pieces of Voldemort's body begin to break off as he desperately wails. His face flakes away, revealing a grotesque screaming skull. Soon, all his skin ignites into flame. His burning skeleton crumbles into a mess of gore and green goo. Joe Walker dies.
Harry, no, don't die.
Everything has an end, Ron. This is mine. Hey, thanks for bringing me back.
No problem, pal. I just didn't think I'd have to say goodbye to you right now.
Well, I guess now would be the time to say goodbye, dude.
Not if old Hagrid has anything to say about it! The end of come, Harry! But not today! Not today!
From within his coat, Hagrid reveals Fawkes the Phoenix, who begins to cry into Harry's wounds with his magical healing tears.
There you go, Fawkes! Give him a good cry, that's it! What it is!
Whoa, I'm back.
Well, chocolate frogs! Harry Potter did it, y'all!
Yay!
Oh, Harry Potter!
Ginny, I'm so sorry I was in such a hurtful mood all year. I was thinking dumping you would really... I thought dumping you would bring me some good, but I was totally wrong. Do you want to date again, maybe? Well, you know what they say. There's nothing really wrong with an old hat.
Oh, boy! I can't wait to go write about this in my diary!
But Hagrid, what about Scarfy?
I'm sorry, kids. The Phoenix tears don't work on clothes.
Scarfy.
He died how he lived, throwing caution to the wind. And he wouldn't want you kids to be sad for one moment. He would have wanted you to be gay. Look! You see, Mr. Shacklebolt, Harry Potter has defeated the Chamber of Secrets monster. The school is safe. It doesn't have to be destroyed.
It seems so. But you kids, rushing past my men, fighting a giant snake all by yourselves and going directly against the orders of the Minister of Magic? Those are magical felonies. Why think I just might give magical medals to all you little heroes?
Yeah! Yeah!
Pull up here, Strike Boys. Hogwarts is here to stay.
Word!
Yeah! Yeah!
All the students who were petrified have magically come back to life. Except for Colin Creevy, who unfortunately died.
Yeah.
Yay!
Whoa. Wipe out. I can't believe that the Chamber of Secrets was in the girls' bathroom all along. I guess the rumors are true. Salazar Slytherin built this place so he could watch little girls pee.
Hermione, wait, what's this? A ring?
Just as a true Gryffindor can pull the sword from within me, it is said that someone who is truly in love can pull a magical ring out of Scarfy's folds. It's his last gift to you, Ron. I think you know what to do with it.
I think I do.
I've got to explain things.
No, Ron. You don't have to explain anything. I could see and hear everything while I was petrified. I've already told the wizard cops what Mr. Filch did to me while I was petrified, and he's being arrested at the moment, so. But I also know that it was you, Ron Weasley, who brought Harry back to save the school and me.
Yeah, wait, what did Filch do to you?
Ron, I've been thinking about it, and you know what? Gilderoy Lockhart is a creep, and his books suck. Would you mind staying with me, even if I am waiting till marriage?
Well, you won't have to wait long. Hermione Jean Granger, I want to get another kiss. So will you marry me?
And me! Yes! Yes, wizard god, yes!
I did it! She said yes!
Hey!
Shut your fat face, you fart mouth! She said yes to me!
No, good sir! She said yes to me!
Oh my. Two boys want my kisses. Now I know how Katniss feels.
Yeah.
Well, that's it, guys.
Senior year is over.
I think we all graduated.
And Voldemort is gone forever. Unless there's some other unrelated piece of his soul floating around out there that we don't
know. I doubt it.
So I guess that means, Butterbeer's on me!
Yeah!
No, 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 no! What kind of a headmaster would I be if I allowed that? Butterbeer's on me!
Dean, you son of a gun.
Love you, man.
I love you. Oh, you crazy woman. Neville, I'm gonna even miss you, pal.
Goodbye, Mr. Potter.
I'll see you, buddy. Bye, Luna.
And hi, Harry Potter.
Bye, Cho.
Well, suppose this is goodbye? You sure showed Voldemort, didn't you?
Yeah, it's pretty dangerous to be one of my enemies. That's why it's a good thing that we're friends.
Well, guys, let's go see what's next.
You all ready to go, buddy?
Yeah, I am. I just, take it easy, Hogwarts. It has been totally awesome.
Scene 7. Lights up on platform 9 3/4, 19 years later. A wizard conductor blows a whistle and calls out, All aboard! All aboard for the Hogwarts Express!
All right, son. This is it. It's your first day at school.
Dad, I'm scared. Could you come with me?
No, no, son. My time at Hogwarts is done. But you listen to me. You don't have to be scared of moving on to something new. Why? You're named after two of the bravest men I ever knew. So go ahead and get on that train, Albus Scarfy Potter. Because now you get to go to Hogwarts. Now you get to go to school. Now that you get to go to Hogwarts, I hope you find that swimming pool. Half two witches, half wizards, and magical beasts, two goblins and ghosts, and two magical feasts. It's all that I loved, and it's all that you'll see at Hogwarts.
Hogwarts.
Man, I'm glad you get to go.
Thanks, Dad.
I'll see you next year, boy. I love you.
I'm going to miss the train to Hogwarts. Come on, laddies, we're so late.
Coming, coming, coming. That was my fault.
No, not at all. That was my fault. Hey, do I know you?
No, oh no.
Oh, it's so funny, my scar kind of tingles. Well, see ya.
Voldemort, that was Harry Potter.
I know, Quirrell. I hear everything that you hear.
Should I?
No. Just let him go. You know, Harry Potter, he helped me once. He taught me something. He taught me that it's all right to let go of things that hurt us. He taught me to open my heart up to what's new. Harry Potter gave me a new family. He taught me how to love. And I guess that's kind of what Harry Potter's all about. But you know, there comes a time when you have to move on, Quirrell. A time when we have to let even Harry Potter go. And that's okay.
Voldemort.
Yes, Squirtle?
Okay is wonderful.